We are live, Gaurav.
All right, welcome everyone to Digital Public Speaking Championship 2020 by MS Talks India. दोस्तों, this is your host and host GJ Gaurav Jain. मैं स्वागत करता हूँ आप सभी participants का, jury members का और सभी हमारे honorable guest का. हम लोग शुरुआत कर रहे हैं हमारा day 2 of Public Speaking Championship 2020 और आइए दोस्तों शुरुआत करते हैं कुछ musical अंदाज में. So मैं इनवाइट करना चाहूंगा वोकलिस्ट गौरव भारद्वाज का, जो कि इंटरनेशनल परफॉर्मर है. ही हैज हिज ओन बैंड गेट जी बैंड, ही हैज इवेंट कंपनी कॉल्ड गेट जी एंटरटेनमेंट्स एंड ही हैज डन मोर देन 1000 शोज ऑलरेडी एट अ नेशनल एंड इंटरनेशनल लेवल. सो ऑल द बेस्ट टू यू गौरव, ओवर टू यू एंड लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड.
थैंक यू सो मच एंड सब लोगों को मेरा नमस्कार, ईच एंड एवरीवन एंड ऑल द बेस्ट टू एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ एज़ वेल. So I'm starting as it's a lovely song, Blues One Love, one of my favorite guys. Hope you will love it. Here we go, enjoy the music.
It's kind of funny how life can change, can flip 180 in matter of days. Sometimes the boxing means to your face. One day you wake up, go without a trace. I refuse to give up, I refuse to give in love. You're my everything. I don't wanna give up, I don't wanna give in love. So everybody sing, everyone in the house, here we go. Sing. One love for the mother's pride, one love for the dancing cried, one love gonna stay alive. Oh yeah, I will survive. One love for the city street, one love for the hip hop beat, one love for what you believe. One love is all we need. Everyone, give me a girl. A one, two. Late at night out, still wanna be. Will this be far more than I can take? I touch my heart to memory. Now I know that one big mistake. I refuse to give up, I refuse to give in now. You are my everything. I don't wanna give up, I don't wanna give in love. So everybody sing, everyone. One love for the mother's pride, one love for the 10 feet grind, one love gotta stay alive. Ooh yeah, I will survive. One love for the city streets, one love for the hip hop beats, one love what to believe. One love is all we need. Baby, just love me, love me, love me. Baby, just hold me, hold me, hold me. Oh, love me, love me, love me. Baby, just love me, love me, love me. Baby, just hold me, hold me, hold me. Baby, just love me, love me, love me. Oh, all right. One love for the mother's pride. One love for the taxi cried. One love for still alive. Ooh yeah, I will survive. One love for the city streets, one love for the hip hop beats, one love for what you believe. One love is for everyone. One love for the mother's pride, one love for the chance we drag, one love gonna stay alive. Ooh yeah, I will survive. One love for the city streets, one love for the hip hop beats, one love. What you believe, all love is all we need. Ooh. Well, thanks, buddy. Thank you, GJ. Thanks, everyone. सब लोगों के मुझे नाम याद नहीं, but फिर भी सब लोगों को बहुत-बहुत शुक्रिया. Thank you so much. एक और गाना, it's a lovely song sung by, I guess, Arijit Singh. Maybe, I don't know the name, but it's from the Kabir Singh, सबने देखी, I guess. Here we go. बंठन के आए हैं सब लोग, देखते हैं क्या क्या होने वाला है. Here we go. Lovely song.
just for lovely people in the house.
बंधन की मुटिया पटोला पड़के करना देव चटिपल पतियां बाहीं छोड़ा खके बंधन की मुटिया राइयां पटोला पड़के करना देव चटिपल पतियां बाहीं छोड़ा खके मेरे सोने सोने रे वे माही मेरा कितने मयो दिल लगना नंगे पैर तुरना पे तू है नाल मेरे तामे क्यों अटरना वे दोनों ने हसना दोनों ने रोना सबनों है दसना वे मेरे सोनिया वे माही मेरा किसे मयो दिल लगना मेरे सोनिया वे माही मेरा किसे मयो दिल लगना वे माही मेरा कितने नहीं लगना वे माही मेरा कितने नहीं लगना बंठन की मुटिया राइया पटोला बड़के कन्ना दे विच पिपल पतियां बाही छोड़ा सनके
Let's have a package song in the house. Yeah, there we go.
All right, this is the final song of the house.
Thumbs up. Dance, guys, like this. Here we go. Oh, 1, 2.
Na 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 na.
Any guesses, everyone? One more check.
Chula jata. किसी की धुन में बढ़ते दिल के तराने
में
जाता हूँ किसी की धुन में
बढ़ते दिल के तराने में मिलन की मस्ती भरी आँखों में हजारों सपने सुहाने एवरीवन हियर वी गो चला जाता हूँ किसी की धुन में ये मस्ती की नजारे हैं तू ऐसे नहीं सुबला कैसा मेरी कसम जो लहराती डगरिया हूँ तू फिर क्यों ना चलूं मैं बहका बहका रे मेरे जीवन में ये शामा ही है मोहब्बत वाले समान एवरीवन हियर वी गो चला जाता हूँ किसी की धुन में धड़कते दिल के तराने
लिए
चला जाता हूँ किसी की धुन में धड़कते दिल के तराने लिए बड़ा अच्छा लगता है जब लोग स्पीकिंग चैंपियनशिप में गाने वाले मिल जाए सारे के सारे कितना मजा आता है ऑल आर टैलेंटेड पीपल बहुत रिस्पेक्ट है सभी लोगों थैंक यू सो मच बहुत अच्छे लग रहे हैं सारे के सारे ऐसा लग रहा है मैं साथ साथ में बैठ के गा रहा हूँ लोगों के ऐसा लग रहा है इतने दूर है हम लोग एवरी गो द नेक्स्ट वन वो आलम भी अजब होगा वो जब मेरे करीब आएगी मेरी कसम कभी भैया छुड़ाएगी कभी हंसी गले से लग जाएगी हेरी बाहों में मचल जाएगी वो सच्चे झूठे फसाने लिए हो चला जाता हूँ पब्लिक स्पीकिंग चैंपियनशिप में हजारों सपने वादे लिए
Everybody,
yeah.
जोरदार तालियां गौरव के लिए. गौरव यू रॉक डेट मैन. एंड लेट्स फेलिसिटेट द वोकलिस्ट गौरव भारद्वाज. आई रिक्वेस्ट शेरी भाई टू फेलिसिटेट हिम. यू हैव डन अ ग्रेट स्टार्ट. व्हाट अ रॉकिंग म्यूजिकल अमेजिंग स्टार्ट. लव्ड इट एंड एवरीवन वाज डांसिंग.
नमस्कार गौरव. फैंटाबुलस एज ऑलवेज.
Thank you.
We would like to felicitate online to you. Thank you for your outstanding performance, Gaurav. Let's have a round of applause for Gaurav Bhardwaj.
Gaurav Bhardwaj.
Thank you.
Thank you for being there. Thank you. Really look forward towards the end also for a marvelous performance once again.
Thank you.
Over to you, Gaurav.
Thank you so much. And after this lovely, amazing musical start, dosto, ab hum start kar rahe hain hamara Digital Public Speaking Championship 2020 Day 2. Aur aaj hamare saath mein bahut sare surprises hain, bahut sari news hain, bahut sara fun hai. To sabse pehle main swagat karna chahunga hamare jo Honorable Secretary hain, Subhash Sharma ji, Advocate Subhash Sharma ji. So, can we have Subhash Sharma ji? Let's felicitate him. Subhash ji, welcome.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much, Gaurav.
And then I would like to invite our jury members, of course. And I'm going to start with none other than retired Lieutenant Dr. Rita Gangwani. She is an entrepreneur, motivational speaker, personality development coach, actress, author. Oh, my God. Wow. It's really a pleasure to have you, ma'am. Welcome to the Public Speaking Championship 2020.
Thank you.
We have few words from you. Just to get started.
We would like to felicitate you, Dr. Rita Gangwani, ma'am. It's been an honor to have you.
Thank you so much, MS Talks and team, and especially Sherry, sir. And thank you, Kara, for bearing with me and my complaints. What words I need to say? In fact, I'm here to listen to people rather than speak. But I will just take about 2 minutes and just 2 minutes or maybe a minute to say that I think it's a great, great platform to encourage public speaking, because I think the second biggest fear people have is of public speaking. And most of the people completely freeze when they are in front of people. So I think it's a great platform to encourage them, get them out of that phobia and fear, and give them an opportunity to express themselves from the heart. And I actually look forward, because when I went through the list, I saw such diversified topics today. And some of them, I don't have much of an idea. So it's a great learning experience for me as well. I thank you once again for inviting me. And I'm looking forward to a very fruitful and a knowledgeable day. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And now I would like to invite our next jury member, Mr. Rajiv Narang. He's a sales and marketing consultant and CEO of AIPL Brand Buzz. Rajiv ji, welcome.
Thank you so very much. Am I audible? I think
yes,
I
yes, you're audible, visible, full on.
All right. Fir kya aur kya chahiye zindagi mein?
Yes. It's always great to have you, sir.
Yeah, I mean, like, if you're audible and if you're visible, I think that is exactly what this platform is doing.
Wow, well said, sir.
It's actually this platform which is giving this opportunity to all the participants to be visible, to be audible, and practice what they've chosen to as their life, as public speaking. You know, so that is something which I think is wonderful. Thank you so very much for making me a part of this program, MS Talks team, Arthur Sherry. I feel very nice. And yesterday was a rocking day. I'm looking forward to have some more rock stars talking and creating and sharing their stories with us. I think it's going to be awesome. And as Dr. Gangwani said, that it's going to be a learning experience. Yes, it is going to be a learning experience. Because as I mentioned yesterday also, it is not about the participants who are going to learn and talk. It's about more of for us. And that is what brings us back to these kind of platforms. Thank you. Thank you once again. And all the best, rock stars. Rock it.
Thank you so much, Ajit ji. Thank you so much for coming and gracing the occasion. And I would like to invite our next jury member, Pearl Priyanka Behel. She is a personality architect, bilingual coach, kitchen groomer, Mrs. India International, 300 plus award winner, director of Empower Kids Personality School, and she have the Priyanka Behel Grooming Academy. So welcome, Priyanka ji.
Thank you so much, Gaurav. Thank you so much, MS Talk. It feels like absolutely pleasure. Rajiv sir and I, we have witnessed some great talent. We miss Rita ma'am though. And I personally here want to mention, I have also been privileged to get grooming under Rita ma'am. And anybody from like Sushmita Sen to Aishwarya Rai, you name a celebrity who hasn't got her magical touch and hasn't got elevation in the life. She's a super guru today here, humbled and always, you know, always like learning and just spreading the kindness. We're so happy today I'm sharing this platform with her, and absolute honor to see all these talented speakers to come over and share their perspective. Look forward.
So sweet. Thank you so much for coming and gracing the occasion. And Sherry bhai, I would like to add on ki bada acha lagta hai jab mentors jo hain wo mentees ke saath mein baat kar rahe hain aur jo mentees hain wo bhi mentors ban gaye hain. Unke bhi aage mentees aur wo bhi mentors hain. So amazing, you know, chain and this thing. Such a proud feeling. When you see your mentee doing amazing things and then, you know, opening up the abundance whole universe is seeing. So what a great platform MS Talks India is, who is, you know, witnessing this amazing transformation of so many wonderful people. So all you participants, this is a time, this is a, you know, hold your playground. Just come here, play, and all the very best to everyone. Anything is possible. So let's get started with our digital producing championship. Can I request author Sherry to share a video? Amazing video, you're gonna get a glimpse of what is going to happen today. Some super strong video. And dosto, now it's my really privilege and honor to invite the man himself that, of course, we are talking about author Sherry. Everyone knows about him. He's a founder and president of MS Talks India, founder and CEO of Public Speaking Institute. He's a professional keynote speaker, 6 times international TEDx speaker, 3 times Josh Talk speaker, author of international bestsellers, belongs to a family of 1, 2, 3. Now, 4 generations of authors, his dad, his daughter, his wife, and the author Sherry himself. They all are the authors of one family. And PSU, Public Speaking University, is founded by author Sherry in 2010 as an online community, which has now grown up one of the India's largest community on Facebook with around 2.2 lakhs public speakers worldwide. Amazing. What a commendable, you know, amazing, you have got achievements. And dosto, when he can do it, we all can do it. He is a live example in front of us who is changing people's lives all across the world. And dosto, as I say already, we are live. So if you want to share the link, the link is in the chat room. Otherwise, you go into Facebook, Public Speaking University, you can share it on your profile so that everyone can see you live here. And now the time has come. Can I request author Sherry bhai, you know, sir, to just come and say a few words and then we're going to get started. Over to you, author Sherry.
Thank you so very much, GJ, our wonderful host. Thank you for your kind words and introduction. It's been a privilege to host all of you, all the public speakers. You'll be excited to know that we have got public speakers today from more than 17 states of India. And we have got some wonderful industry experts, Dr. Rita Gagwani, Honorable Rajiv Narang sir, Honorable Priyanka Bahel, all are stalwarts in their field and who are going to judge you. And it is important to mention that more than 8 students of mine today are performing. So my dear fellows, today is a real test for all of you. And as Dr. Rita mentioned that it's a platform, it all started 5 years back when I saw that there is no platform for the common man of India. And that's when I came up with a thought and idea that why not to create a platform? There are many platforms for celebrities and micro celebrities, but there are hardly any platforms for common man, common people of India. So that's when I thought about creating MS Talks. And today we have given platform for speaking to aspiring orators, professional speakers, public speakers across the globe. More than 15,000 public speakers have come and shared their stories, insights, workshops, seminars, and it is just going. It's going to be much more than what we are talking about here. So my dear friends, today Digital Public Speaking Championship 2020 is happening. It's a day two. We have seen wonderful performances on day one. And I'm sure today is going to be even more rocking. Some surprises are waiting for you, especially for the winners. And I always try to over-deliver and under-commit. So that has been always the promise. So let us start by giving you an overview of DPSC. So we all are on the same page, though I'm sure you must have seen everything related to the inquiry form and the categories. So first of all, if I talk about the category, we have 7 categories, my dear friends. First is entertainment. Second is technology. Third is storytelling. Fourth is communication. Fifth is personal growth. Sixth is spirituality. And seventh is business. I'm sure by now you have shared your topic and chosen your category as per your choice for a prepared speech, and prop usage is going to be mandatory. Now, talking about the scoring parameters, we have 5 parameters. The first is soft skill, where we will be checking your language, flow of speech, rate of speech. The second one is non-verbal skill score. Third one is content, how you're presenting your content. That's your presentation skills. And then prop usage. So these are the 5 scoring parameters, and these are the titles to be won. You'll be excited to know that we have best soft skill category, best content, best presentation, best prop as well today. And then overall champion founder's choice, which is going to be decided by me. And we have then DPSC All India champion first, then first runner up, which is the second, and then the second runner up, which is the third. On top of it, we have a great announcement to make, a great opportunity, especially for the people who have put in their hard work. I know it's not that easy as it sounds to come on a platform, whether it's physical or virtual, to speak and share your heart. And one simple mantra, which I want all of you to follow, which I want all of you to remember, is speak by heart. Day before yesterday, I was talking to somebody that how we can innovate our communication. And the simple answer which I try to give is, the more you speak by heart, the more you innovate your communication. On this note, all the very best to each one of you. Let's have a rocking performance. And let me invite Gaurav Jain also now for being a wonderful host. And Gaurav, it's been a privilege to always have you with us as a host. Thank you so very much for accepting the invite and hosting this entire event. It's been always a pleasure working with you. Let's have a round of applause for GJ, our host, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sherry sir. And it's always a pleasure. And it's really my, passion, I should say. So thank you so much, guys. And now we are getting started. I would like to thank our food partner, Havich, health partner, Kairali, sponsors and media partner, Punjab Kesari and Navdrishti Times, powered by Z Premium, Think Machine, Think Lubricant. And dosto, अब हम अपना प्रोग्राम शुरू कर रहे हैं चैंपियनशिप का. मैं आपको कुछ रूल्स बता देता हूं जो कि बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है सभी के लिए. आपको 3 से 5 मिनट का टाइम मिलेगा, और जैसे ही 4 मिनट कंप्लीट होंगे, यू विल रिसीव, यू विल हियर दिस मैसेज.
1 मिनट लेफ्ट.
okay? So the moment you hear this message, you have to complete, you know, jaldi se wrap up karna hai aur koshish karna hai time se pehle hi. Because yesterday we noticed ki some people are taking more time, to uski negative marking ho sakti hai. So very, very important. And don't ask this question, am I audible, am I visible? Agar kahin pe bhi kuch technical issue hoga, toh we will tell you upfront, tabhi hum aapko bol denge. And please use the chat room. Kisi ki koi bhi queries hai, questions hai, confusion hai, anything and everything, we have the chat room here. Please use that. And all the very best to everyone. And now I'm going to start by calling our very, very first speaker. And make sure guys, sabke camera on rahe. किसी को भी रैंडमली बुला लूंगा. सो डोंट जस्ट थिंक कि हम सीक्वेंस फॉलो कर रहे हैं. सीक्वेंस जो है वो यहाँ पर है, ठीक है? तो कहीं से कोई भी रैंडमली आ सकता है. बी प्रिपेयर्ड विद योर प्रॉप, बी रेडी. एंड नाउ लेट्स इनवाइट अवर वेरी फर्स्ट स्पीकर ऑफ द डे, द पब्लिक स्पीकर. नेम इज सुरभि जोशी फ्रॉम गुरुग्राम एंड टॉपिक इज पावर ऑफ वर्ड्स.
इनकलाब जिंदाबाद. जस्ट वर्ड्स. तुम मुझे खून दो, मैं तुम्हें आजादी दूंगा. जस्ट वर्ड्स. फ्रेंड्स, रोमन्स, कंट्रीमैन, लेंड मी योर इयर्स. आई कम टू बेरी सीजन नॉट टू प्रेज हिम. द इविल दैट मेन डू लिव्स आफ्टर देम, द गुड इज ऑफ्टन इंटर्ड विद देयर बोन्स. सो बी इट विद सीजर. द नोबल ब्रूटस सेज सीजर वाज एंबिशियस. And Brutus is an honorable man. Just words. Bhaiyo aur behno. Just words. Greetings to the members of the jury and all gathered here. As toddlers, when we first learnt the A, B, C, D song, little did we know that we would use these letters to make words. Little did we know that we would use these words to make sentences, and little did we know that we would be reeling under their effect all through our lives. What are words? Mere group of vibrations and sound. Yet without them, no thought can be a reality. Words have energy. Words have power. Words have the ability to help, heal, hurt, hinder, humiliate, or make humble. The English language alone itself has 1,26,000 words. If you are a bilingual or multilingual for that matter, your expanse of vocabulary is vast. For a moment, let's imagine a world without words. Gaurav ji kya bolenge? Author Sherry kya bolenge? Aap aur main jaise public speakers kya bolenge? Silent rooms, silent chats, silent gossips. Arnab Goswami silently conducting the debate. We've all started watching a lot of movies on Netflix, languages which we don't understand, Korean, Spanish, and we hang on to the subtitles. Words again. Hum your favorite song without words. La 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 la. Words are feelings, words are emotions. As a teacher, I know the far-reaching effects of words. I can pull a student down by calling him names, humiliate him, crush his confidence, or I can boost his morale, lift him up, make him go that extra mile and soar high, achieve whatever he or she wants to do. A couple of years back, I had the opportunity of attending a school in Ahmedabad where a social experiment was being conducted. The three identical plants were placed in three rooms. Every day, the teachers and the students had to visit each room. The rules were simple. In one room, kind words were spoken to the plant. In the other room, harsh words were spoken to the plant. And in the third room, there was pin drop silence. Needless to say, the plant that received kind words blossomed and bloomed. And the ones that did not withered and wilted. If words can affect plants in this way, how can you and I be untouched by their effect? It is remarkable how we can make or ruin somebody's day. Kitne acche lag rahe ho aaj. Thoda weight put on kar liya na. If you rearrange the letters WORDS, you get the word sword, talwar, which has an equally cutting effect. If you plant a seed of love, it is you who blossoms. If you plant a kind word, it is you who blossoms. Shabdon mein koi to baat hoti hai. Dil ki baat inse bayaan hoti hai. मीठे हों तो कानों में खनकते हैं, वरना शूल की तरह खटकते हैं। दिल के अरमां इनसे निकलते हैं, छू जाएं तो पत्थर दिल भी पिघलते हैं। कीमती मोती हैं ये, व्यर्थ ना इन्हें समझना। कीमती मोती हैं ये, व्यर्थ ना इन्हें समझना। कुछ अच्छा ना कह सको तो व्यर्थ ना इन्हें खर्चना। As Robin Sharma says, words are free. It is how you use them that costs you. Use your words wisely. Know your words worth. Thank you.
Fantastic. Great performance. What a great start, Surbhiji. Very, very nice. Very nice. And dosto, next speaker I would like to invite is Dr. Bela Mohan from New Delhi. And her topic is Healthy and Happy Future Generations. So Dr. Bela Mohan, over to you. Please unmute yourself. Please unmute. I think she is facing a technical thing to unmute herself. So let's move on to the second speaker. Next we have is Nilima Agarwal ji from Faridabad, and her topic is self-empowerment.
Gaurav, I guess Dr. Bela is speaking over there. Dr. Bela, I'm sorry to intervene you, but your voice is not audible to us. Yeah, your voice is not coming to us. Please check your microphone.
आवाज नहीं आ रही, Dr. Bela, आप तार निकाल दीजिए. Move the tar. Yeah.
Unplug करो ना, निकालने से नहीं होगा.
हाँ नहीं, वो हमारी आवाज भी पहुंच रही है कि नहीं, I'm not sure.
All right, Gaurav, you may switch to the next participant, please.
So, do we have Nilima Mohanji here? Nilima Agarwalji, okay. I think Nilima is also not here. Next we have is Ajanta from Bangalore, and her topic is self.
Yes, sir.
Who was that? Please say that again.
Yeah. Sir, Nilima Agarwal here.
Okay. All right. So, over to you, Nilima ji. Welcome, and your time starts now.
काश मैं लड़का होती, काश मैं लड़का होती तो शायद थोड़ा कम बिजी होती। हर सुबह न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ते पढ़ते कॉफी के हर घूंट का मजा ले रही होती। लड़का होती तो मायके और ससुराल के चक्कर भी नहीं लगाने पड़ते। लड़का होती तो फायदा जरूर होता, मगर लड़की हूँ इससे बड़ा फायदा नहीं होता। लड़की नहीं होती तो घर, बच्चे और मेरा पैशन एक साथ नहीं संभाल रही होती।
करना है ना,
हर हद को पीछे छोड़ इतना आगे नहीं बढ़ पाती। लड़की नहीं होती तो कभी नहीं समझ पाती।
नीलिमा जी प्लीज अनम्यूट, आपका म्यूट हो गया है। नीलिमा जी प्लीज अनम्यूट, आपका म्यूट हो गया। नीलिमा जी प्लीज अनम्यूट, नॉट म्यूटेड।
Carry on. Sir, am I audible?
Yeah, yeah, you're audible. Please carry on.
Okay. Yes, we are unstoppable. जिसके पास हर ताले की चाबी है, empower तो हम हैं ही, बस इसका यकीन दिलाना बाकी है। Namaste to everyone. I am Nilima Agarwal, a person with strong determination and hardworking attitude. Here presents my opinion on self-empowerment through self-improvisation. My question is, what do you want? Perhaps this is the most important question you could ever ask yourself, and the first question you should ask yourself. If your intention is to live your greatest life, then you must know, what do I want? Isn't it amazing that nobody is asking this? Why nobody is asking? Well, it's no surprise that nobody is living the life they want. If you don't know where are you going, you will never get there. And if you don't know it, you will never grow into it. If you have never thought of what type of life you want to live or the person you want to become, how on this planet Earth you expect to live your life in future? Nobody knows what they want. So nobody is living the life they want. What do you want? Write it down. Write in details. Be very, very specific. Close your eyes and dream how exactly you wanted your life to be. What would be your relationship be like? Your friends, your family. What would be your health be like? Your fitness, your strength, how much you would be earning, what you must be doing. Your passion, your services to the society. Don't you think there would be more joy, more laughter, more peace, more achievement, more contributions? Work on that, my friend. Work on yourself. What makes you happy? What makes you proud in your future self? Asking and writing are first step, my dear friend, to achieve the life you want and to achieve the goal you want. Claim the life you deserve, and it can only be done by dreaming, by asking, by writing, by desiring the path you want to achieve. We have many, many examples in a real life. There are many unsung heroes. We can say, unka vision alag tha, unki life ki empowerment alag thi. According to them, life is not the way it is supposed to be. It is the way you cope up with, and it is what makes the difference. Here we have Arunima Sinha, a person from being thrown out of the train, losing her leg, and facing an uncertain future, shifted to become the first female amputee to scale the highest mountain in the world. Yes, it was self-empowerment, self-dedication. So they uplifted their life. At last, I would say, live your ultimate life for yourself, by yourself. Take care.
Fantastic. Very, very nice. All right. So that was Nilima. And now I would like to call our next speaker. The name is Ajanta. She's from Bangalore. And the topic is self-worth. Ajanta ji, over to you.
Very good morning, everyone. My name is Ajanta. Today, I am going to speak about self-worth. No one has ever hated you to the extent that you can hate yourself. So, my dear friend, it becomes an utmost necessity that you spend time to build up your self-worth. I really wish building up the self-worth was simply as easy as telling to yourself that you love yourself repeatedly. However, it is not going to work out. If you truly want to love yourself, you must do something that is worthy of that love. You must do something that you have long dreamt of. You must build the credibility with yourself. So that when you say to yourself that you can do it, you will leave no stones unturned to make it happen. You will make all possible steps to make it happen. The reality is we all keep a watch on ourselves. We know what we do. We know what we don't do. We know how we behave. We know where we fail.
My audio.
Our own number one critic. We lose confidence on our own self first. So my dear friends, it is okay to start small. It is okay not to have a big dream. It is okay to forgive yourself. And it is okay to fail. However, when you fail, rise again. Dust yourself, move ahead. When you fail, fail forward. Keep rising. Keep moving. Spend time to build up your self-worth. Now, my dear friends, how to do the self-judgment? I'll tell you 5 easy steps. Number 1, start small. Number 2, know what you want. Number 3, come out of the comfort zone. Number 4, set rules for yourself. And 5th one, the most important one, is follow those rules. So my dear friends, if you progress every single day, you will be able to achieve your goals, guaranteed. You will be able to make the difference in your life, guaranteed. You will be able to build the credibility with yourself in your own eyes as well as in the eyes of others, guaranteed. So my dear friends, every day is a golden opportunity to spend time to build up the self-worth. Every day is a golden opportunity to spend time to fulfill all the promises that you have done to yourself. Every day is a golden opportunity as well as a present to build that credibility in your own eyes, where you promise something to yourself and you will definitely achieve it. Stay blessed. Thank you.
Fantastic. Lovely. Very, very nice, Ajanta ji. Very, very nice. Great.
Sir, I want to say a few words more.
Okay, yeah, go ahead.
Sir, I would like to thank my mentor, Mrs. Priyanka ma'am, who has helped me a lot to prepare. So, special thanks to her. And I really am very, very thankful to MS Talk platform as well, where they have given an opportunity to display the such talents. Thank you.
Lovely. So sweet. And I'm just loving all this program. Why? Because the mentees are giving, you know, thank you to their mentors. Mentors, they're further thanking their authors. That's a wonderful feeling, dosto. And can I request Priyanka ji, Priyanka Behel, to say a few words?
Yeah. Hi, Gaurav. Thank you, Author Cherry. Thank you so much, Ajanta, for the mention. I would really insist, Ajanta, to just share on the Facebook profile the first video. So there had been not a mentoring, but a kind of like her daughter is my student. So while she's shown interest that she want to go into public speaking, I just given her a couple of nuggets what she can use. And she's such a great learner. I always say, you know, the learning is always there in the world. But the moment you are ready, the mentor appears, the teachers appears, right? So learning is everywhere in the world. But that's how she has, you will see her first video, she should upload it. And you will see in just the 3 attempts, she made herself so better. So all credit to her that she has that, you know, flame in her to be better. So that's what I say. I'm so humbled. Thank you so much for considering my all the nugget of wisdom worthy enough to be implemented, and we definitely see improvement here, and lots more to walk, lots more to go, a long way to go. Yes.
Thank you, ma'am.
God bless.
So sweet. Kudos. So ये तो सही है, 2-in-1 हो गया. आप बच्चों को सिखा रहे हैं, बच्चों के जो parents हैं वो भी साथ साथ सीख रहे हैं. Great. Lovely. But it's really, really commendable. And दोस्तों, now I would like to invite our very next speaker. She is a doctor, Dr. Bela Mohan. She is from New Delhi. And her topic is Healthy and Happy Future Generations. So over to you, Dr. Bela Mohan. All the best.
Hello, beautiful souls. I'm on a mission to connect you with your body, mind, and soul so you become a better version of yourself. This is my mission and my vision. Clear vision, I can see. Healthy, happy, beautiful, brilliant, fantabulous, emotionally stable, mentally strong, future generations. दिल से दिल की बात ये है कि मैं आपको कहना चाहती हूँ, आप please मेरी इस मुहिम में मेरा साथ दीजिए कि हमें healthy और happy India बनाना है. मैं डॉक्टर हूँ, मैं कोरोना वॉरियर हूँ, आई एम वर्किंग डे इन डे, अपनी पीपी किट पहन के, मास्क पहन के मैं काम कर रही हूँ. कोविड 19 हैज शेकन अस ऑल. हम सब इनसाइड क्या आउटसाइड क्या सबसे बिल्कुल शेकन हो गए हैं. आर फिजिकल हेल्थ, इमोशनल हेल्थ, मेंटल हेल्थ, स्पिरिचुअल हेल्थ, फाइनेंशियल हेल्थ, इन्वायरमेंटल हेल्थ, ऑल हेल्थ आर टोटली एट स्टेक. सो वॉट माई मिशन इज कि हम इस हेल्थ को स्प्रेड करें, और ये प्लेटफॉर्म जो MS Talk प्लेटफॉर्म है इसको मैं यूज कर रही हूँ अपने मिशन को स्प्रेड करने के लिए. सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर दैट. मैं अपने इस पावर ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन को एक स्टोरी के साथ रिलेट करती हूँ. जैसे कि ये एक बीज है और ये एक ब्यूटिफुल प्लांट है. वी कैन सी वन सीड एंड वन ब्यूटिफुल प्लांट. सीड को ब्यूटिफुल प्लांट बनने के लिए बहुत मेहनत चाहिए होती है. जो गार्डनर है वो सबसे पहले सॉइल को क्लीन करता है, उसमें खाद डालता है, उसकी में पानी डालता है, बहुत प्यार से उस प्लांट को लगाता है, फिर उसको धूप में रखता है, एक्स्ट्रा धूप से उसको बचाता है, उसको इंसेक्ट से, उसको जानवरों से उसको बचाता है, उसको सेव करता है. क्यों? जिससे कि वो एक ब्यूटिफुल प्लांट बन सके. सेम इज द स्टोरी ऑफ वुमेन, बेबी इन द वूम एंड मदरहुड. ये मेरा एक सपना है कि मैं इस मैसेज को आप सबको कन्वे करूं, और ये प्लेटफॉर्म बहुत अच्छा है इस मैसेज को कन्वे करने के लिए. आई एम वर्किंग ऑन बुक वूम टू होम, गर्भ से गोद तक स्वास्थ्य और संस्कारों की यात्रा. व्हाट आई मीन टू से कि हम जब हमने पेंडेमिक 19 फेस किया तो हम इमोशनली इतने स्ट्रांग नहीं थे, पर अगर हम वूम से, जैसे कि आपको मैंने बीज और इसके बारे में बताया, अगर हम वूम से अच्छे संस्कार, हाई मॉरल वैल्यूज, अच्छा न्यूट्रिशन वूम में ही से ही बच्चे को डालना स्टार्ट करेंगे अगर हम, तो हमारी फ्यूचर जनरेशंस हेल्दी, हैप्पी, इंटेलिजेंट, उनका EQ, IQ, SQ सब कुछ बहुत हाई लेवल पे होगा. तो वी रियली नीड टू वर्क. आई एम रियली कंसर्न अबाउट ऑल एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ हेल्थ ऑफ माय फ्यूचर जनरेशंस. आज इस वक्त पूरे हमारी सोसाइटी में, हमारी इंडिया में कितना डिस्ट्रेस है. वी आर सो शेकन अप. इसके लिए अगर हम वूम से ही स्टार्ट करेंगे तो कितना ईजी हो जाएगा हमारे लिए. जो वूम में बेबी होता है वो बिल्कुल सॉफ्ट क्ले जैसा होता है. इट्स लाइक अ ब्लॉटिंग पेपर, इट एब्जॉर्ब्स ऑल द वाइब्रेशन. तो अगर हमें नेक्स्ट जनरेशन को और ज्यादा पावरफुल बनाना है, उनके सोल को और स्ट्रॉन्ग बनाना है कि वो हर चीज को अच्छी तरह ब्रेवली फेस कर सकें, तो वी नीड टू स्टार्ट राइट फ्रॉम टूडे. आज से ही प्लीज एवरीवन, जो भी इस मेरे वीडियो को देख रहा है, जो भी मेरे को सुन रहा है, आप आज ही प्लेज लीजिए कि आप मेरे साथ जुड़ेंगे एंड वी टुगेदर कैन चेंज द वर्ल्ड. हम नेक्स्ट जनरेशन के लिए बहुत और बहुत काम कर सकते हैं, उनको बहुत स्ट्रांग, बहुत मॉरली स्ट्रांग. हम सब ने माइथोलॉजी में बहुत सारी स्टोरीज सुनी है, अभिमन्यु की, भक्त प्रहलाद की, शिवाजी की, ये सारी स्टोरीज हमने सुनी है. आज साइंस इनको प्रूव कर रही है. बड़े बड़े गायनोकोलॉजिस्ट, साइकोलॉजिस्ट सब इसको प्रूव कर रहे हैं. आई थिंक ये वाला जो चैप्टर है, जो ये बहुत वास्ट है, आई कैन कीप ऑन स्पीकिंग फॉर आवर्स एंड आवर्स एंड इट इज वेरी क्लोज टू माई हार्ट. मैं दिल से चाहती हूँ अपना ये मैसेज कन्वे करने को, बट आई थिंक टाइम पूरा हो रहा है, तो मैं बिफोर एंडिंग, नामुमकिन कुछ नहीं है जिंदगी में, नामुमकिन कुछ नहीं है जिंदगी में. कुछ कर दिखाने का जज्बा हो तो लोग जुड़ते जाते हैं और कारवां बन जाता है. सो प्लीज आप लोग मेरा साथ दीजिए, और जब मेरी बुक आएगी तो प्लीज उसको आप पढ़िएगा और आगे इसको स्प्रेड कीजिए इस मैसेज को. थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू एवरीवन.
वेरी नाइस डॉक्टर बेला, वेरी वेरी नाइस. और दोस्तों हम अपने इस कारवां को आगे बढ़ाते हैं और बुलाते हैं हमारे नेक्स्ट स्पीकर को. सो नेक्स्ट वी हैव इज समवन अलोन, हिज नेम इज संतोष अकेला एंड ही इज फ्रॉम मुंबई एंड द टॉपिक इज कीप ड्रीमिंग. Over to you, Santosh ji. Your time starts now.
Thank you. Hi friends, how are you doing?
Great.
So I just want to tell you all that there is only one difference between Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam and me. If you see, Kalam had dreams, and even I have dreams. But the problem is, I only have dreams. Because if you see, in my school, my teachers always told me that if you are having 100% attendance in the class, then it is not for the attendance, but it is for being there and sleeping in the classroom. And that was a kind of student I was right from my childhood. And then I came to college days, and my college days were even more competitive because all my friends were having and giving outstanding performance in academics. And I started to give peak performance on bet. Okay, I'm just speaking about my sleep. Don't misunderstand me. And then I came to my final year of my college life, and I had only one dream job to do, and that was being a mattress tester. I wanted to sleep on hundreds of mattresses every day, and I wanted to test those mattresses. But unfortunately, I could not attend that interview as well because I overslept on that day. And today I'm very glad as I woke up today and I'm here. So dear friends, do you know what? Many miracles in this world also happened only because people were sleeping. Take the example of early man. Early man was lazy, sleeping through a rock, and we have fire today. An apple fell on Isaac Newton when he was sleeping under a tree. Not when he was running or jogging or doing some physical activity. And then I joined my job. And I joined in an IT company thinking that, okay, this is not my life that is going to be, and I can easily sleep on bench. But things were very tough because my HR was very strict and she allocated me to a project that went in the morning shift. And I slept for 3 years at work, and obviously I was not promoted as well. So my parents and everyone started lamenting that you are sleeping, and hence your memory, focus, attention, logical thinking, everything is getting impacted. And I think they're right, because I often tend to forget things and repeat them. So I wanted to grow in my career, and I tried a lot. I did not get that. So finally, what I did was, I wanted to achieve my dreams when I'm sleeping. Yes. So if you are not able to achieve your dreams in reality, why not achieve them in dream itself?
1 minute left.
Today, just now, when I was having a small power nap, I got a dream that I won this competition. Today I go to meditation classes in the mornings, not to meditate, to see and get the happiness of people, hundreds of people closing their eyes and get that happiness. I started embracing my sleep, my dear friends. So one thing that I want to tell you all is that if you are not able to do something, try to embrace it, be it sleep. I embraced it. I love to sleep now, and I live my dreams. Whatever I cannot do during the day, I live them in my sleep. So this is my one message to you all, is to embrace things as they are. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Wonderful, Santosh. Very nice and interesting. And I request everyone to please use the prop clearly. It is very, very important because the theme is on the prop based. So you have to showcase your prop very, very clearly to get the best marks. And now, friends, let's invite our very next speaker. We have is Carolina Pillai from Pune, and the topic is life, the universe and everything. Over to you, Carolina. Time starts now.
What's that? But before that, would you believe if I say that you can conquer this universe and everything within it? Wondering how? By simply taking control of your life. I am Carolina, here to give my persuasive talk on life, the universe, and everything. The abbreviation of the term LIFE gives us a culmination of a set of words that act as a remote to control your life. The letter L in life stands for liberate. Do not squeeze yourself into a glass ceiling that is defined by the society, largely patriarchal, as your achievable goals. Now, the term patriarchy reminds me of the game of chess. I began to generate hate for this royal game when I learned the trick of a queen's gambit from a grandmaster. Now, the queen's gambit is a strategic play of sacrificing your powerful queen at the early stages to trick the other player. The queen in this game has phenomenal powers. She can move up, down, left, and right. But the king, on the other hand, can take only one step at a time. But the grandmaster sacrifices his queen to make the king win. But the question is it always necessary to win? Now, this drives me to the rule of liberation. Be fearless. Be flawed. Do not be afraid to take risks. And in order to do this, you will have to bring out the individualism hidden within you. This drives me to the letter I in life, which stands for individualism. Evolve and hunt for your individualism in this world of labels. Now, when you do this, you will face failure. Now, something that is as certain as birth and death, and even day and night, is the fact that we all are going to fail. And that is why letter F in life stands for failure. It is way better to be a failure at something that you love than being successful at something that you absolutely hate. At this instance, I am reminded of the story of a young girl. Now, this girl could hardly read or even solve what 6 into 8 was in her 9th grade. Her teachers presumed that she had a mental illness and advised her to join a school that was meant for special kids. Her family, though were very supportive, knew that this girl would drown. And they were right. This girl was drowning, but only until she realized that you do not drown by falling into the water. You drown by staying in there. Do not drown in the waves of your own sea. Learn how to swim and evolve. Remember, my friends, every time you fail, you fall. But you fall a step forward. As Thomas Edison rightly said, many of life's failures are people who did not realize how close they were to success when they gave up. And lastly, in this human race, do not forget to empathize. The letter E in life resembles empathy. I learned this somewhere and it stuck with me. I hope it helps you too. Empathy is being able to understand that a war is both won and lost. And somebody else's pain is as meaningful as yours. Now remember, do not compare anybody else's highlight reel with everybody else's behind the scenes. Having said that, if somebody fails to empathize with your pain, remember, do not fall prey to their ideologies. Because if that young drowning girl I mentioned before would have, then she would not be standing before you today as a scholar who topped in her 12th board and represented Maharashtra. She would not be a person who is still continuing to top in her college boards. And that is me. I stand here sharing my story to you to learn how to go through this process of life. Though I'm very young, remember that the journey of life has very few routes. And if you capture them, you will definitely be able to conquer it. So now you know what is the battery to your remote. So pick up your batteries, know what liberate is, individualism is, and what failure and empathy is. Use them to conquer your universe and everything within you. And trust me, you will succeed. Dream, live free, and evolve. Dream to breathe lives into the aspirations that you have created and not what somebody else has been defined or born into. And that is my talk for you. Thank you.
Super awesome, Carolina. You are like unstoppable. Very, very nice. Amazing. Kudos. And dosto, it is time for a poll. Abhi aapke screen pe ek poll aayega. Just have to vote out the best option you think it is. So can we have the poll? Here it is. This is only for the participants. We'll be closing this poll in a few seconds. Let's make sure everyone participate. And we will announce the results of the poll as well. Okay, around 23, 24 people out of 38 have answered. Okay. 65% people have voted. Okay, we have got a few more seconds before we close this poll. All right, so here we have the result. 61% of the people, the question was, whom do you think will win the DPSC 2020? And the highest number of votes, it is given 61%, it is participant who speaks by heart. 25% people have said participant who uses a prop with intelligence and asked them, jitna hai, I win that DPSC today. Very, very nice. Great. As you can see, the results in front of you, and you may expect some more polls in few times. Thank you so much. And now let's move on to our very next speaker. I would like to invite Gohan Kumar from Dilwalo Ki Dilli. And the topic is COVID-19, a blessing in disguise. Gohan ji, over to you. Your time starts now.
A very good morning to all of you present here. So this is my prop, an ex-Covidian. 11 June 2020 would have been the worst day of my life, but it actually turned out to be the bestest day of my life. How? I got famous. How? Because that day I got tested for positive corona. Oh no, you guys could be wondering, is this guy all right? Is this guy mentally fine? इसको कोविड हुआ है एंड ही इज टेलिंग दैट इट इज द बेस्टेस्ट डे ऑफ हिज लाइफ. यस, बिकॉज दैट वाज द डे ऑफ माय ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन. सी, आई हैड टू ऑप्शंस एंड बिफोर दैट 8 PM आई गॉट द रिपोर्ट्स. माय मॉम एंड डैड, दे वर डेवास्टेटेड, टोटली डेवास्टेटेड. माय वाइफ वाज इन कंप्लीट शॉक एंड माय किड हु इज एन इन्फेंट हैड एक्चुअली नो आइडिया व्हाट्स गोइंग ऑन. Actually felt like my kid, because I was myself thoughtless. I was feeless. I didn't actually know what happened, but it happened. I had two options with me. Either I could choose a life of misery and negativity, or be optimistic towards whatever is going to happen is going to go awesome. And yes, it did happen awesome. So rather than putting it across that I was put under 18 days of quarantine, I was under 18 days of meditation. And yes, the positive part about it, what I learned was being self-dependent. Self-dependent? By self-dependent, I mean, मैं झाड़ू खुद मारने लग गया, मैं पोछा खुद मारने लग गया, मैं अपने रूम का सैनिटाइज मैं खुद करने लग गया. And second point, I made it a point that I will make my responsibility to make myself happy, no matter what. Third, I made a point that I get in touch with my long lost friends. My long lost friend whom I had lost in touch with, networking. I did networking. I even talked to an ant who was trolling up the wall and it actually did listen to me. Jab upar upar chad rahi thi. Fourth, I was myself and I composed a song. I became a director of my song. So from that song, I would actually, you know, recite few lines which I love the most. Every morning, I look up in the mirror. My vision becomes clearer and nearer. Every morning, I look up in the sky and I wonder, 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 wonder why. That was also the name of my song. Let faith and patience take my side. Shout out to my unfinished dreams, which are still inside. So after all this, my wife actually told me, you know, Gohan, ek video banao where, you know, ki aapko remedies wagera ke bare mein aapko baat nahi karni, because remedies and all, you guys would already be knowing ki, you know, Google is there to actually tell about ki remedies kya face karni hai, kya nahi karni. But here, I want to share the purpose of my story is to tell you that how actually COVID-19 transformed me. I was a chain smoker. I quit smoking. It's been like 4 months. And the video which I made, it actually was viral. And it was viral like a fire among the bushes.
1 minute left.
It was so viral that it reached the management of my bank where I'm working. I would like to actually share this with you. This was a marriage. This was the video was went so viral that it reached the top management of HDFC Bank and they told me, Gohan, we have been inspired by you. Thank you. Thank you so much. And after that, few of my colleagues came down to me and they told me, yaar, mujhe bhi corona ho jaye. Mega bas, ye nahi. In the end, I want to tell you, be positive. It's your mind. It's all in the mind. Don't be corona positive. Be positive. And that, by the way, that's my blood group too. Thank you.
Super awesome. Fantastic. Go on. Love your confidence, man. Very, very nice. Kudos.
Thank you. And, thank you.
Dosto, now I would like to invite our very, very next speaker. And the name is Rohit Kumar Koka. He's from Bangalore. And the topic is very interesting. Kill it off. Rohit, your time starts now.
Mommy, why are you crying? What happened? Nothing, Rohit. I'm just cutting onions. But why are you crying? Because onions make you cry, Rohit. Why? My mother had two options here. Either tell him that the synthase in the onions causes sulfonite to become sulfonic acid and that becomes phenpropanethyl S oxide that causes us to tear up. But she knew the next question would be, why? So instead she did what all mothers do best and told a story. Rohit, once upon a time, the creator came down to earth to enjoy the magnificent creation. While cascading through an open vegetable field, a sudden downpour of rain came thundering down. The creator had nowhere to go, so started running around to different vegetables asking for shade. All of them refused. And just as the creator was losing hope, an onion saw the creator and said, "Oh, my creator, please, you're getting drenched. Take one of my layers and cover yourself. But wait, won't it hurt you?" "Yes, it will. But not as much as seeing my creator get drenched." And the onion peeled one of its layer and gave it to the creator. The creator felt so touched by the generous act that he gave him a boon, saying, "From this day forth, onion, whoever cuts you, peels you, or hurts you shall cry like the rain that has fallen upon me. My dear Rohit, since that day, whoever cuts, peels, or hurts an onion cries. Yeah, that was my reaction from that story. Maybe all of yours as well. My dear onions, very good afternoon. Yes, we are all onions, but not like the onion I just told you about, but onions nonetheless. Let's understand. Like an onion has layers and layers underneath its core, you and I have layers and layers underneath our core. These layers have accumulated since the time we were a toddler and maybe in the form of name, gender, region, religion, race, caste, creed, or maybe in the form of bachelor's, master's, postdoctorate, doctorate, PhD, or maybe in the form of employee, manager, engineer, doctor, CEO, politician. We've become so identified by these layers and titles that we've forgotten who we are on the inside. We are all human after all, yet we treat each other so differently because of these layers or titles. I ask you right now, peel it off so you can be one step closer to who you are on the inside. Now, like onions make us cry when we peel them or cut them, you and I make others cry when they peel our layers. I realized this when I was in class 6th, because at that time, the layer that I had on me was that I was the man of the house and I had to defend my mother's honor. So in an argument with one of my classmates that got a little heated up, he ended up saying uncharacteristic remarks about my mother. That was it. My layer was provoked without a second thought. Boom! Knocked him on the ground. And I was proud. I stood like this in the principal's chamber, feeling proud that I defended my mother's honor. But in that very same room, my mother stood like this. While the teachers and principals said, "What kind of parenting is this? Is this what you teach your son at home? This is what happens when a single parent is taking care of a child." My mother, the proud woman that she was, for the first time had to put her head down because I was provoked. My layer was peeled. Never again. I said, no way. And I said, I'm not going to let that happen. And I peeled my own layer. I let it out. Today, what you say about my mother doesn't matter. What she is and who she is defines who she is. I don't have to defend her honor. Rather, respect it and be there as her son. I've become lighter and renewed after peeling my layer. My dear friends, like me and like that onion story, we all have different layers. We identify ourselves with these layers so much that we forget who we are. So I'm asking you, don't be like the onion that peels itself and makes others cry, but instead be the onion that peeled its own layer to give shade to someone else. Peel it off, feel renewed, give shade to others. Find out what's in your core. Thank you.
Fantastic. Amazing style you got, Rohit ji, and we have a question for you from Author Sherry. Yes.
I will call you Coca, you know that, right? So Coca, I have a question for you. So I can actually visualize the story. You have done so much of hard work in your performance. I want to ask you, what are the top three things, if you would like to share, not necessary, if you would like to share, what are the top three things you did to prepare at this level?
First of all is understanding what is my message. When you're a public speaker, the first thing you need to always ask is, what's the message you want to give to the audience? And that's the first thing I wanted to understand, that my message is all about, you know what, peel off your layers, find out who you are, don't be so overcome by these titles and layers. That is my message. And of course, the next thing was finding a prop that suited that message. So the onion is the perfect example of it. And then it's all about going backwards. The way I like to structure my speeches is begin with the end in mind. What is it you want to give your audience? What is it you want to leave your audience with? If you start with that, the rest of it will flow very easily. Most of us struggle to find out where do we start, but start with the end.
Excellent. Thank you so very much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Author Sherry, for asking this question. And thank you, Rohit ji, for answering that amazingly well. And it's an inspiration for everyone, dosto. And now it's a time to call upon our very next speaker. Here's a fantastic kid. Let's invite Mr. Daksh Behel from Faridabad. And the topic for him is success.
When I was in class 8, my physics teacher took our whole class to physics lab to demonstrate how does a pendulum work. Seeing the pendulum switching from one side to the other, I was convinced that eventually it would come to a standstill right at the center without being on either of the extremes. I thought to myself that so many things in our life depends on being centered and not tending towards extreme polarities. Over the years, I have met many people who had achieved huge success in their life, but they credit their success to their entrepreneurial nature, to their efforts and to their endeavors. They believe that it's their hustling alone that had brought them to where they are today. Indeed, you can smell a sense of arrogance in their attitude and tone. After all, in this unfair world, they have carved a place for themselves. The self-made ones, one extreme of the pendulum of success. And then I've also met those who credit their success to the right people, to the right timing, to the golden opportunities that they had in their way. Maybe to karma, luck, or destiny, and some to even higher powers of God. These individuals are honest in acknowledging that there are people and forces beyond themselves responsible for their success. And these are the blessed ones. Most often they come across the modest, but they believe that they had no role in their success. Another extreme of the pendulum of success. Finding success in what we do is such an incredible balance. As human beings, we have a free will, we have independence, we have the ability to choose. And indeed, it is the purposeful use of that free will in directing our energy, power and resources into the right direction that brings us success. And that success, that achievement, gives you self-confidence, belief in your unlimited potential. But then we can also not deny the fact that our independent efforts reach a limit, a plateau, and unless help comes from outside, it is hard or even impossible to move to the next level. It is at that time we start realizing our insignificance. We start realizing our dependence on factors outside of ourselves. Self-confidence in our potential now transforms into humility by calling out for help or assistance. And those who had always thought that they are dependent need to balance their modesty with self-esteem. After all, the roadmap may be given to you. The car can also be given to you. But unless you drive the car, you may not reach your destination. So we all should acknowledge that we have an important part to play in this journey of success as well. Ladies and gentlemen, the day that I walked out of my school, I was enriched by what the pendulum taught me. Our success is a combination of our independent efforts and our dependence on other people and forces. It is the combination of belief in our self-worth and having to know that we have often limitations that can be offset by the kind help of other people and forces. This balanced approach makes success real and satisfying. Thank you.
Wow, fantastic. You have completed your speech within the time. Very nice. And can I request Rita Gangwani ji to, you know, say a few words for the performances till now? Rita ma'am, over to you.
I'm actually speechless. Each speaker has their own style. Some people are very good with humor. Some people are very good with their body language. Some people are explaining their props very, very beautifully. So I think it's a wholesome package each and every one is giving, and it is actually truly very, very difficult, I'm sure, for the jury to actually mark them. But wonderful speakers and great stories and great research they have done in writing that, limited time kind of a story. But I actually really don't have words because I'm personally learning a lot and I'm taking notes as well. So thank you once again to all the speakers. It's really, really inspiring to listen to all of you, each with their own style. And I'm actually happy that nobody is copying no one. They're bringing out their own uniqueness, their own individuality through their speech, through their body language and through their expressions. And I'm really, really amazed. Thank you.
Thank you so much for your inputs, Rita ma'am. Very, very nice. And now there are many speakers left. Friends, And we are moving on to our very next speaker. Now, I would like to invite Mr. Nagila Suresh Kondinya from Chennai. His topic is related to social media. His dangers of digital footprints. Interesting. Over to you, Nagila ji. All the best. And your time starts now.
It is Hyderabad, not Chennai.
Oh, it is written Chennai. Anyways.
Almost 3,000 years ago, Eratosthenes, a Greek philosopher, said, the world is round. And people threw stones at him for telling that. He said, the world is round. And I believe the world is round. There are so many oceans, continents, and all that. 3,000 years later, it took another scientific genius to prove that wrong. And actually, I'm blushing because the scientist is me. Because I believe the world is now only 4 by 2 inch. This. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, this is the world today for everyone. And what does this contain? I will show you. Everyone, first you open it like this. If this is my world, this is my lifeline. This is my oxygen. And this is where we are leaving our digital footprints. Why I say digital footprints? Once I was returning from Singapore, I took a 2-day detour and came home. My wife was looking at the photographs. Suddenly a question popped up there. How was PP massage Pattaya? I was blown. I had to use all my creative genius to avoid bloodshed at home. Then I realized, whatever I am using my apps for, I am being tracked. Wherever I go, I am getting tracked. And the kind of likes I do, the kind of reactions I express, either on Facebook or Instagram or any other social media, it is getting tracked. Technology is good. But to what extent this technology we have to use? And by the way, these people are not charging you. Why? If somebody sells you a salt, you give money, take the salt, use it. Somebody sells you a mug, you pay money, you use it. But all the social media, they don't charge you. So then what are they doing? Why are they doing like this? Because for them, you are the commodity. They are selling you. And how they are selling you? Based on the digital footprints, what you are leaving in these apps. I do any kind of activity. Now the world has come. I post something over here. Okay. I most of you will agree. The moment I post in Facebook, I just don't leave my mobile there. After 2 minutes, I go and see how many likes I have got, who has liked it, who has commented it, and I reply back to them. Every time I do this, my activities, my interests, what kind of post I am reacting to, everything is getting tracked. And that is used on you again. Why it is getting used on you? Your modification behavior is happening. Think 10 years ago, what was my behavior and what is my behavior today? Because based on whatever apps I am using, I am leaving a certain trail. Based on the trail, the messages pop up on the social media. That is how my behavior is modified. And they very well know what kind of ads to push on to you. Because whatever I am doing on these apps, my footprints have given a clear proof and indication that this fellow will definitely like this ad, respond to this ad. But do we stop using technology? No. Gone. Gone are the days where Shakespeare used to ask to do, not to do. That is over. The question for us today is what to do, what not to do. Because what not to do is very important for us. Otherwise, we are going to get tracked. Every time I go there, every time I use something, I am leaving certain essence over there.
1 minute left.
And after a certain time, nobody needs to tell you. As an example of Pattaya, I said, even if I put this mobile in my pocket, I walk from my home to the vegetable market and come back, this will know that I have gone to a vegetable market and come back. So how to avoid this kind of a tracking? There are a lot of ways. It is just to ensure, use it as only a social exchange, but don't reveal too much. In the childhood, I used to write a diary and I used to feel very bad if somebody reads it. Today, I post something on this and I feel very bad if nobody sees it. That is how my behavior has modified because of this. Avoid giving much of a personal data. Just use it for social interaction and don't overexpose yourself to the kind of posts which are happening. That will ensure at least some of the digital footprints we are avoiding. Thank you.
Fantastic. Great, Sarishji. Very nice. And next speaker we have is Mr. Akshat Gupta from Dehradun. And the topic is becoming the best version of yourself. Akshat, over to you and all the best.
Okay, thank you, sir. Warren Buffett once said, the more you learn, the more you earn. Very well said. A very warm and healthy afternoon to everyone present here. Today, I, Akshat Gupta, would like to tell you that you should become the best version of yourself. Look at successful people like Bill Gates, Steve Jobs, Elon Musk, Oprah, Mark Cuban, and any other highly successful human. They are successful because they use their time right. They are successful because they are lifetime learners. They commit to learning new things every single day. Warren Buffett, one of the most wealthiest humans on the planet, is famous for reading more than 5 hours a day. Bill Gates reads one book per week. Mark Cuban, 3 hours a day. Oprah, well, she's just obsessed with books. Notice the common theme here? Successful people never stop learning. Okay, think about this. You have 86,400 rupees to spend every single day. But when the day is over, the money disappears. You can't get it back. Wouldn't you try to spend all of the money before it disappears? Wouldn't you try to use it wisely, use it as best you could? The sad part is, we only have 86,400 seconds in one day. And most people take this time for granted. Most people let this time disappear without even a second thought. Like, we never get this time back. We must use it wisely. We must be productive. We must use time to do things we enjoy or to set up our life so we can spend our future doing more things we want to do. Instead of wasting your time on meaningless things, use it to learn new things. The time you spend playing video games, or partying with friends will never come back. Once you use the time, it's gone forever. Use your time wisely. Read books, study hard, and learn as much as you can. Most people give up on their dreams because it gets too hard. A lot of students stop chasing their dreams because of one failed test. Matter of fact, most people don't even try their best when they're giving the test because in their mind, they've already failed the test. They stop believing in themselves, and once the belief is killed, the dream is killed. If you have a dream, then you must do everything to make it into your reality. It doesn't matter how much you have failed. You must move on. Life itself is a test. Sometimes you will fail. But the only way you can be a failure is if you stop trying. Well, once a very famous author said, "Haar ho jati hai jab maan liya jata hai." Haar ho jati hai jab maan liya jata hai aur jeet ho jati hai jab thaan liya jata hai. If you are wondering who said these wonderful words, it's none other than our lovely author Sherry. Thank you, sir. Whatever dream you have, use all your energy to make it into your reality. Push yourself to become the person you are destined to become. Success is not about the money, the fame, or a big house. It's about becoming the best version of yourself. You will fall down many times on the road to success, but the most important thing is that you get back up. You get back up stronger and wiser than before. Create a mindset that does not allow you to quit or stop believing. If you quit on your dream or give up, you will never know how great you can be. Never doubt yourself. Doubt kills more dreams than failure ever will. Work on yourself every single day. This is your life we are talking about, bhai. There is nothing more important than this. Thank you.
Wow, super awesome, yeah. Kya khakar aayo? Look at your energy, man, Akshay.
Thank you, sir.
Fabulous. Can I ask Rajiv, sir, to say a few words?
I am actually dying to talk to this guy. Akshay, you are just awesome, bache. Tu bahut hi cute hai yaar, itna badhiya bol raha hai. Meri smile nahi hat rahi hai. And I can
really thank you, sir.
Future. I can really see the future which you are going to take. Aur mujhe na, Sherry sir, I'm sure aap isko mentor kar rahe ho. Mujhe isse ek bar baat karni hai, isse pehle ye star bane. So I want to talk to him one to one. Phone pe baat karaiye mujhse kabhi. कभी ऑटोग्राफ लेने आऊंगा इसके.
Definitely.
मेरे इस कमेंट का कोई लेना देना स्कोर्स के साथ नहीं है, बट आई थिंक आपका आपका जो वो जो एनर्जी थी ना, वो मेरे को पहुंचती जा रही थी, पहुंचती जा रही वर्चुअल है उसके बावजूद भी मेरे तक पहुंच रही थी, और मैं सिर्फ मुस्कुरा रहा था, हंस रहा था, और आपकी प्रैक्टिस देख के बहुत अच्छा लगा मुझे. आई थिंक यू वर्क वेरी वेल एंड इट रीच्ड मी, आई विल बी वेरी ऑनेस्ट. सो लव यू बच्चे, गॉड ब्लेस यू.
थैंक यू सर सो मच.
एंड कैन आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑथर शेरी एज वेल से फ्यू वर्ड्स.
Thank you so very much, Akshat. It's always a pleasure watching you performing, and I can see today atom bombs are exploded on the screen, and you are one such atom bomb who exploded today. Aur main ek cheez bolna chahta hu, Hindustan ka future bright hai. Mera mission zarur pura hoga. Aap jaise bacche agar aa karke aisa powerful performance denge na, to Hindustan mein zarur kuch bada hoga, ho raha hai aur hota rahega. Hindustan Zindabad.
Thank you, sir. Hindustan Zindabad.
Super awesome. And dosto, now it's time to call upon our very next speaker. And next we have is Jaspreet Kaur from Ranchi. The topic is Judgment of Women by Society. Over to you, Jaspreet. Your time starts now.
Thank you so much, GJ. You are doing a great job as usual.
So,
hi everyone, greetings of the hour. I am Jaspreet Kaur Bodraj from Ranchi. The society always makes the women insecure of what they do, what they eat, what they wear, and how they look. Don't you think this thing of the society should change now with the changing times? Arey, usse dekho apne aap ko kya samajhti hai? Itni naati hai, isiliye to itne lambe lambe heels pehenti hai. इतनी मोटी है फिर भी उसे गुलाब जामुन चाहिए. इतने छोटे कपड़े पहनती है. ऐसी लड़कियां तो रेप को बुलावा देती हैं. फ्रेंड्स, हैवंट वी हर्ड दीज स्टेटमेंट्स थ्रोन बाय द सोसाइटी एट सम और द अदर पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम्स इन अ लाइफ ऑफ अ वुमेन? डोंट यू थिंक दिस शुड चेंज नाउ विद द चेंजिंग टाइम्स? इफ अ वुमेन टॉक्स टू मच, the society comprehends her to be a feminist. If she doesn't, she is comprehended to be shy and timid. If a woman laughs too much, the society comprehends her to be easy and crazy. But if she doesn't, she is appeared to be serious and solemn by the society. The society leaves no stones unturned in labeling a woman. Married to auntie, सिंगल तो लेम और अनमैरिड तो शेम शेम. वही अगर लिपस्टिक थोड़ी ज्यादा हो गई तो ए हीरोइन. व्हेन अ वुमन वेयर्स अ रेड लिपस्टिक द सोसाइटी कॉम्प्रिहेंड्स हर टू बी वेरी बोल्ड एंड सेक्सी एंड समवन हु इज नॉट वांट्स टू शो हर अदर साइड ऑफ हर्स द सेंसुअल एंगल ऑफ हर्स समवन हु डजंट माइंड शोइंग दैट एंगल ऑफ हर्स. So do you think a woman applies a lipstick only to show it to the men, only to show it to the men so that they get attracted towards her? No. The reason is lipstick. When a woman applies a lipstick, the woman feels more confident about herself. More confident, it enhances her personality, her self-esteem, her appearance. When a woman applies a brown lipstick, the society comprehends that might be she's a chain smoker. And because of that, her lips might have turned brown and she's applying a brown lipstick. Nude shades are generally applied by women of a younger age, basically the teenagers. But when an elderly woman applies a nude shade, the society comprehends that the woman is trying to hide her age. So is that the reality, friends? When I talk of women being judged by the society, I not only talk of women being judged by other men, I also talk of women being judged by other women of the society. So I would just like to say, embrace yourself because you are what you are. Embrace your imperfections because that is what makes you you. Embrace the glorious mess you are and don't forget to apply a red lipstick unapologetically and confidently. Thank you so much.
Very nice, Jaspreet. And I love the painting as well in your background. And I have a question for you. I mean, you are have really, really touched an important topic. It's a critical topic. And I just wanted to, curious to know that who prepared you and who is your mentor?
My mentor is the one and only Sherry, sir. And I'm proud to be his mentee.
Okay. Wow, you were really amazing. Very, very nice. All the very best. God bless you. All right, dosto, after Jaspreet, let's invite our very next speaker. And now we have Divya Maroda from Faridabad. The topic is time. Time's priority, need of the hour. Divya, over to you. Time starts now.
Time is a created thing. So if you say I don't have time, is to say, I don't want to. A very good afternoon to everyone. My name is Divya Maroda and I'm speaking on the topic, time's priority, need of the hour. There is no such thing as not having enough time. There is only what you make as priority. You make the time for what you must have. You make the time for the people you want to be around. You make the time for your musts. If you need to sacrifice for what you must have, you'll need to sacrifice. If it's not a priority, you won't work for it and you will never have it. If you are like most who have made probably survival a priority, getting by, paying the bills, doing the minimum, right? You can choose not to live that way. We can choose to do more. We can choose to be more. There is no such thing, my friend, as lack of education. Self-education has made more millionaires than school will ever will. There is no such thing, my friend, as talent. Hard work will always be talent. But do you want it bad enough or you're too lazy to work for it? If you believe, you will reach your definition of success. Opportunity will show up everywhere, everywhere you look. I choose to make a priority in my life. Big dreams and things I must have. I must have abundance. I must have great health. I must set an example to my family. An example to anyone who crosses my path. An example of I can. An example of when I say something and I do it. An example of nothing is off limits. Nothing is impossible. There's no truth in the statement like you can't get in best shape of your life. Whatever you make a priority, you make life a priority. Your success a priority. Your health a priority. Your happiness a priority. Your greatness a priority. And choose to make your greatness your biggest priority. Thank you very much.
Very nice and interesting. Lovely, Divya. And so next we have is Rachna Suri from New Delhi. And her topic is storytelling. Wow, let's hear what story she have. Rachnaji, over to you and your time starts now.
Okay. Have you heard this phrase? Abracadabra, gili gili shoo.
These are magic words spoken with a magic wand. But real life mein aisa koi magic hota hai kya? No, no, no. I learned this fact a very hard way and discovered that all the powers lie within us. And when once we discover this, then nothing can stop us from achieving anything in our life. Hello, everyone. I'm Rachna. And today I'm sharing my personal story with you of rock and roll. Stay tuned. I'll take you back to November 2007 when my daughter was born. Everything was going on very well. It was only when my 40-day period finished, मेरे को अपने शरीर की मांसपेशियों में एक अजीब सी कंपन, फड़फड़ाहट, टाइटनेस और एक इंटेंस पेन महसूस होने लगा. I simply could not figure out what was happening to me. And the shock of my life came when one morning I wanted to pick up my daughter from the bed and my whole body, my head was stuck on the pillow and I simply could not lift my body. I was crying and yelling for help. My husband and maid picked me up, helped me to stand on the floor and enabled me to take one or two steps. But nothing seemed to be possible for me. My whole body was burning and bursting with intense pain. To my surprise, I was diagnosed with rheumatoid arthritis at the age of 28. RA factor in the blood, which is supposed to be 50, mine went up to 2,198. All the doctors and lab technicians were shocked. Unko samajh nahi aa raha tha ki ek human being ke liye is tarah ka pain sehna kaise possible hai. And I was consciously living with it with a 2-month-old daughter by my side. Then the course of medicine started. We tried everything from here to there, from everywhere. And nothing seemed to work on my body. The pain was growing day by day and it covered me from head to toe. Then I got a steroidal painkiller, ek pudiya sort of a thing, which used to give me respite for 6 hours, a painkiller sort of a thing. And I used to stand on my foot and do small tasks with a lot of discomfort. The pain remained the same. I was gaining a lot of weight and nothing changed. This course lasted for 2 years and after it, I resumed my job. Life was moving, nothing was changing in my body, nothing was happening. After 7 years, I came across a book by Anita Murjani, Dying to Be Me. I discovered self-love. I understood what it was. School mein hum iske baare mein bataya nahi jata, society doesn't talk about it, so practically we have no idea about it. When I understood what self-love was, an inexplicable yearning developed within me to know myself. Khud se khud ka rishta jana, the questions badal gaye. From why this is happening to me to what it is trying to teach me, the questions were dated. Then in the year, with these riffles happening in my mind, I could see my inner thought process was changing. Then in the year 2016, I was blessed with a baby boy. And to my surprise, I had no fear of the disease. But after the 40-day period, the disease again struck. But it did not make me a handicapped, paralyzed person as it made me in the earlier instance. And with the steroids and painkillers, I was managing. Then I said to myself, enough of it. And I am going to take charge of my body. My weight, which went up to 92.5 kilos, and the disease remained as it is. I gave up on my job and started reading books. I came across a book, The Power of Your Subconscious Mind, and understood your subconscious beliefs, your habitual patterns, and the technique of creative visualization. I started seeing myself in the best possible and healthiest version in my own body. I started seeing myself standing on the foot, barefoot on the floor, doing different exercises, burpees, squats, everything that I could think of. Main apne bete ko stroller mein dal ke dopahar ke baad short walks leni maine start kari. Through that, I started my journey of weight control. Then I started telling myself about the disease. I started understanding its causes, symptoms, why it happens, which food causes it, which controls it, how much sleep is needed, how your thoughts affect it, everything. I surfed YouTube, listened to videos, podcasts, listened to documentaries. Dr. Deepak Chopra, Dr. Warner Dyer, Dr. Robin Sharma, everybody became my guides and angels. And yes, it happened. After 3 years, in 2019, I was 95% disease free. And I came off all the steroids and painkillers. Gratitude so much for that. I understood that the universe has shaken me to awaken me. Then the desire cropped within me to motivate the people around to find this innate treasure which we all hold within us and we are not aware of. I started seeing myself speaking on the stage and motivating people. And here I am today, virtually speaking to all of you, telling about it. I like to conclude by saying that I'm Rachna, which means creation, and I consciously create my reality today, tomorrow, thereafter, and so on. Thank you and gratitude. Thank you so much.
Wow, very nice sharing, Rachna ji. Very, very nice. And dosto, an important announcement. Hamara ye jo abhi event hai, wo Facebook pe live hai. Uska link hai, wo aapke screen pe aa gaya hai, chat room pe. Kindly share it so that you are being watched with everyone. Please share it with everyone so that it can inspire anyone and everyone around the world. Because I must say, so much amazing sharing is happening right now. So much inspiration. And we all are learning so many amazing things. So that was Rachna Suri, and next we have is Ashmin Kaur from Dehradun, and the topic is communication with I and you. So over to you, Ashmin, and your time starts now.
Frustrated, annoyed, and in a bitter mood, she threw off her bag in the room. Of course, she had a bad day because her presentation was awful. And so she... Am I audible? Is my voice clear? Oh God, what is happening? How quick our reactions were when this communication chain broke. Did you all feel frustrated or irritated that another technical glitch? Well, on my part, I felt nervous. Imagine these technical glitches as those potholes on the road, which makes our journey full of discomfort. Exactly. These gaps and hindrances create a rift in our communication. By the way, what does this word communication mean? A very good afternoon to one and all present here. Today, I will be talking about communication. When we impart or exchange knowledge by speaking, reading, or using some other medium, it is known as communication. An interesting fact is that communication is one of the most important skills in life. Now let's come back to Shruti. Hey, why are you looking at me like that? I was talking about Shruti. Remember in the beginning of my speech, the girl who was frustrated and annoyed? Her speech did not go well. After a lot of strenuous efforts, she lost one of the most important clients just because she lacked in communication skills. So can I say that communication skills play an important role in an individual's professional life? Yes, communication does play a very vital role in professional life as well. I remember an incident, my cousin trying to convince her mother to let her go on a picnic alone with her friends, which turned into an unpleasant argument. The story behind the curtain was that Shreya wanted to go for her picnic and her mother was not allowing her as they would get late in the whole process. But somewhere, she forgot to tell her mom that two of her friends' moms were accompanying them. I gathered a few points through this incident that communication should be concise, clear, courteous, concrete, complete, connectable, and considerate. Now, these seven C's of communication are as important to learn as we learn the seven continents of the world. Each C gives a value addition and is important in our lives. Now, many people have a misconception that if they know English, they are good communicators. Well, that's not true because English and communication are two very different things. English is a language that can be learned. But communication is a skill which also can be developed. It doesn't mean that having good English determines how good you are at communication with others. As the word itself suggests, communication is all between you and I. You might have heard people talking about communication with others, but what about communicating with our own self? The fact is that if we do not communicate with ourselves, we can never communicate with others. As the saying goes, it begins with you. So give time to yourself, talk to yourself, and look into yourself. And if the communication between I and I is clear, definitely the road of communication between you and I
will have no hindrances, no gaps, and no holes. Thank you.
Very nice. Lovely, Ashmin. And dosto, next I would like to invite Shruti Verma from New Delhi. You're going to guess the topic. Over to you, Shruti. The best.
Thank you, Gaurav. Hello, everyone. Today I have something to show you. This is a bouquet. Can I request you all to type in the flower that you like the most in the chat box? I will show you each flower one by one. If you don't know the name, you can type the color of the flower that you like the most. I'm short of time, so I hope everyone's done by now. Thank you. I'm so sorry to tell you that I'm not going to check the chat box to see which flower is liked the most. Why? Maybe I'll tell you later on. Now, just have a look at this bouquet. You will see a variety of flowers. Each flower is different from another flower, size-wise, shape-wise, and in many other aspects. If you look at this orange flower, you'll see that no other flower as bright as this one. But at the same time, no other flower can symbolize love and friendship the way this rose does. Similarly, each flower here is unique, and when they come together, they form a bouquet. You must have been thinking that why am I explaining this to you? Well, my objective here is to convey that all the participants here today are just like these flowers. And this championship denotes the bouquet. The topic I'm going to speak upon is the power of participation. Now, whenever it comes to a competition or a championship, all that matters is who won, the person who came first. After some time, nobody even remembers who stood second. So all those who participated is not even a question. If rest of the people didn't win, does it mean that participation means nothing? I beg to differ. Now, if you look at these flowers once again, you will see they all come from different backgrounds. Some are younger than others, while some are older. Some had to survive the hot sun, while some had to live in a cold environment. Some had to grow with thorns, while some needed more water to stay alive. What I wanted to say is, we all come from different backgrounds, different states, different cities, different age groups, or even different experiences. I know we are going to have a winner today who would be the best of us all, but still the bravest step is to take part in the competition. Gathering the courage to participate by keeping all your challenges apart is what makes you a winner already. After all, nobody can learn something new in life or have a new experience until they don't try or participate. I would also like to mention that yes, victory definitely matters. After all, this is what we all are here for. But at the same time, there has been no winner in history who wasn't a participant first. It's a repeated effort and participation only that serves as a staircase to your destination. If you win, it gives you confidence. If you don't win, it makes you more humble and tells you about your weaknesses and strengths. So in the end, I would just like to say that I have no idea who is going to be the favorite flower of us all today, but this bouquet wouldn't have been possible if we all wouldn't have been a part of it.
1 minute left.
Do you remember I asked you to select your favorite flower in the beginning? Honestly, I think all the flowers here are too unique to be compared. Winning and losing is a part of life, but participation is where the strength persists. So keep participating and be proud of yourself, because you are a unique flower of your own kind and too precious to be compared with anything else. Thank you.
Very nice, Shruti. What a graceful and lovely performance. And can I request Rita Gangwani, ma'am, to ask Shruti any question you want to?
Shruti, first of all, I normally train people for pageants, and many a times it is so difficult for me to tell them that out of so many girls, just one, two or three are going to be a winner, because they always feel very disheartened. But it was such a great analogy you used with the flowers, and I mean, it really inspired me. So where did this idea come from? That's my question. I've been thinking about it since ages. Never came to me.
Ma'am, since I've started public speaking, before that for many years I've waited to be able to participate. I was always too afraid. Once I started, I always just wanted to win. Whenever I didn't win, I was used to be completely devastated. But you know, every time when I lost, the rest of the 2 days that went bad, when I never talked to anybody and switched off my phone and always angry with myself, I realized that I'm actually becoming more humble. I'm understanding that there are better people, people younger than me, people older to me. I have always something new to learn. And every time I was participating, I was becoming better, a better version of myself, actually. Wonderful. So I think participation is what actually makes you grow. If you win, that's completely fascinating. You always want it. But still, if you fail, please keep on participating, because even if you don't win, you are winning to be the best version of yourself somehow.
Wonderful. And I just love that line you used, that every winner was once a participant. Wonderful.
Thank you.
Great going. Thank you. Thank you.
Super awesome. And
Shruti, I'm proud of you. Yes.
Thank you, sir.
And Sherry bhai, I would like to add on here ke aapke itne sare jo aap competition lekar aate hain, digital public speaking championship, online public speaking championship, we have seen lot of people who have had a great transformation, and these guys are the one who are continue on a participation mode. So kudos to you, Shruti, for lovely sharing and fantastic performance. And let's invite our very next speaker. We have Mr. Gurdeep Dhillon from New Delhi, and his topic is who are you? No, the topic is who am I? So over to you, Gurdeep ji. All the best. Please unmute. Yeah.
Hi friends. This is a Corona time, and everything we want to know, we are covered with masks. We are having a mask on ourselves. So, how we are going to recognize that who am I? I am not talking about who am I. I am talking about everyone over here. Do we really realize who we are? How many of you, I would like if you can raise your hand and tell me you know really who you are. Do you really know? Can you raise your hand and tell me, acknowledge me that you are able to listen, my voice is reaching you. Can you raise your hand and tell me you truly know who you are? I only see one person raising his hand, the Rajiv sir. But rest of us are still asking the question to ourselves that who we really are. Before starting, I would like to show you certain things. You can see the name and the designation. Oh. Now, the name and the designation. The name is same, but designation changes every time. Designation changes. And now, I am from technologist turn to spiritual enthusiasm. See the name, the identity, but is this identity is what I am? Is this identity or these designations prove who I am? Who actually I am? I really, really want to understand this. And this question brought me to the world of spirituality.
This question got me into the era of spirituality. And here I came to know that spirituality doesn't start with God or doesn't start with anybody else, but it starts or it begins from you. So, who I am? Who I am is a journey to go deep inside us. Who I am is a journey of learning about our true self. The agenda of this talk is to provide you the information about our true self. How we can able to know, how we can able to get to the gist of what we are and the problems we face while getting to know who we are. One is always a stranger to one's real self, and that is actually the ignorance. That is actually the reason why we took birth. What is the reason? We always ask this question. What is the purpose of my life? Why I am here on this planet Earth? What is there in Earth which I want to explore? Do I really want to explore the material aspect of the Earth? Or what is this word spirituality? From where it comes? These words, are these words coming from the universe? No. These words, these languages, these religions, these everything are made up by humans. So we need to understand that we need to get over our wrong beliefs. Our wrong beliefs are like, I am my name, I am my designation, I am my identity given by the world to me. We need to get to understand that I is ego. I is ahankar. I is not me. I is in true form. It is the God. I is the creator. And my, if you relate myself, my name is Gurdeep Thilam. Myself, I'm developing as a spiritual group, but spirituality can't be taught. My is Maya. So we need to differentiate between I and Maya, and the day we are able to differentiate between I and my, we are able to reach to the gross level of I. As Swamiji told yesterday about five tattva. So we are made up of five tattva, but in gross level. We will talk further later on in our further discussions. Till then, thank you. Shabbat.
सो मच गुदीप जी. एंड दोस्तों, आप लोगों को टाइम का ध्यान रखना है, बहुत बहुत जरूरी है, और हम अपने कामों को आगे बढ़ा रहे हैं. उससे पहले मैं थैंक यू बोलना चाहूंगा हमारे फूड पार्टनर हैबिट को, हेल्थ पार्टनर काइराली, स्पॉन्सर्स एंड मीडिया पार्टनर पंजाब केसरी एंड नवदृष्टि टाइम्स, एंड पावर्ड बाय जी प्रीमियम, थिंक मशीन, थिंक लुब्रिकेंट. एंड दोस्तों, नेक्स्ट वी हैव इज रुचि कन्वर फ्रॉम न्यू दिल्ली. द टॉपिक इज माय लाइफ जर्नी. Ruchi, over to you. Your time starts
now. Imagine this is a piece of raw gold. It has to be melted, beaten, shaped up, and then we get something like this, an ornament which we wear, admire, and get inspired. God has also made all of us like a raw piece of gold with beautiful uniquenesses within all of us. But we have to go under process so that we can inspire others, admire others, and make our own journeys with a real purpose of life. We have to find out our real goal. Hi, I'm Ruchi Kanwar, inner alchemy coach, entrepreneur, and an upcoming author. I would like to take you all back to 1976 when I was born to the most adorable parents, given best of education, and got married at a very early age of 19 years, blessed with two lovely daughters by the age of 22. But I always wanted to do something in my life. I completed my graduation and pursued primary teacher training. Due to family constraints, I was not able to continue it. So I switched on to vocational courses. I started taking classes on candle making and chocolate making. But again, due to some environmental changes, I was not able to do that too. I switched on to anchoring and started taking live shows. But in this money-minting world, people are not ready to share their funds with newcomer artists. I was not being paid anything, so I have to stop it. One day, when I was just sitting at McDonald's with my daughters, I met a stranger. He introduced me to the concept of network marketing. And within a time span of 3 years, I made a team of 6,000 people, which earned me a Hyundai i10, a driver, and a beautiful cook. Now, with all these things, I was just enjoying my feast, and suddenly my elder daughter fell ill. I lost her at the age of 15 years, battling for 2 years. My complete life was shattered, and I was completely in darkness, and the only thing I was doing was ardas to my Lord Almighty to give my daughter back. At the age of 39, I again conceived. I got my daughter back. But again, a big challenge came to my life. My husband met certain medical issues, which brought him to bed. Now a 4-month-old baby, one daughter in 10th class, and husband who was not able to do anything, again throw a biggest challenge of looking after the financial needs of the family. I was not able to go anywhere, leaving all these three. So I have to do something from my home. I sold some of my gold and learned few again, professional courses on soap making, which was very trending at that time. And I started participating in exhibitions. By the grace of God, I just not only got people to reorder their stuff, but I got reseller and partners who believe my products are really authentic and impactful. Today, I have a team of 5 to 6 women for whom I make products behind the scene, and they sell them through their own brands, and we all share the profit together. This gave me another mission. There are several women around me who may be facing the same problem: time, life, lifespan, time, then challenge of talent, education, money. And I know how to grow all these things together and face these challenges. I completed my neuro-linguistic programming last year and did coaching training to coach others. And today I'm very blessed that I have actually helped 2 women to stand up on their feet from standing nowhere to a level where they have not only grown their business, but have been covered by YouStory.com and several newspaper coverages. This mission has also helped me in several other things to grow myself. I've also coming up in the mid of this November with a book, Root of Abundance, in which I have shared all my journey and obstacles I have faced in my life and then bounced back to it. By the God's grace, this publication house is being named after my own daughter, Saiba, and I want her name to flourish everywhere, and people from throughout the world come to this publication house to get their real stories published. Thank you so much, and I hope my journey will inspire someone or the other, and faced any of, no matter what sort of challenge you have faced in your life, believe in God and believe in yourself. You can bounce back to any situation. Thank you so much.
Lovely. Very nice, Ruchi ji. And dosto, more than half of the speakers are done. Only few speakers left. And jo results announce honge, wo aaj dopahar 3 baje announce honge. So all the very best to everyone. And there's an important announcement that author Sherry from MS Talks India is coming up with a 21 days free course. It is starting on 7th of November till 27th of November. For participation, enrollment, and registration, kindly get in touch with the team, Tara ma'am. Thank you so much. And now it's time to call upon our next speaker. Ruchi, you want to say something?
Yes. First of all, I would just like to thank author Sherry. He's such a wonderful person. No matter, kabhi bhi inko call karke kuch bhi pooch lo, he will revert back. So much regards to him. He's such a down-to-earth person I've ever met. And Rita Gangwani ji, I hope you remember, she has used my soaps. I have met her at many events at Zindagi Delhi also, where I have hosted a show. And gratitude to God, she is again a big inspiration for me in my life. And I'm really full of gratitude meeting all these people on this platform. Thank you so much, author Sherry sir, for this wonderful platform. I can revise all things. Rita ma'am ko main kitni baar mili hu, kitni baar maine unhe apne hampers diye hain, kitni khushi se wo us cheez ko accept karti hain. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Very nice. So sweet.
Ruchi, you're most welcome, and thanks for your kind words. Your story is very inspiring. God bless you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
All right. And I must say, life is full of surprises, dosto. So keep doing the things you love to do. Keep following your passion. And next we have is Mr. Yash Kumar from Faridabad. And the topic is behavior. Yash, over to you. And your time starts now.
So Good morning. Today, I want to share with you a powerful story about a snake and a saw. Before you question what the snake and a saw do with our life, well, it's about much more than a snake and a saw. It's about what happens to us when we react in anger. What happens to us when we hold on to resentment. It's about what happens to us when we hold on to the grudges. And when we don't let to go negative emotions. And when we want negative things happen to others. So the story is this. One night after closing time of a furniture factory, a snake find its way inside a factory. Snake lither around. It cut itself with a saw. Thinking saw was a thread, snake slept around the saw and bit the saw. Of course, this caused more damage. Now, not understanding what was happening and thinking saw was the enemy, snake grabbed the saw in attempting to suffocate it. And you can imagine what would have gone. Snake didn't do any damage to the saw. Instead, ended up being killed by the sharp blades of the saw. Snake ended up being killed by his own anger. A powerful message here often. When we react in anger rather than compassion, we hold on to resentment. We hold on to the grudges. The negative energy which we carry around will only makes us suffer, only makes us suffocated, never a person we might want to suffer. So, we always have a better chance to ignore negativity. Negativity is the way to fail. To ignore negativity, the better to let go the negative things towards others. It's always a better to enjoy the life. We can for ourselves. We should create the best life. When we look up the things with the perspective, it's much easier to move on. It's much easier to renew the things. But when we hold on to resentment, when we hold on to the grudges, it's not easy to move on. Like the snake. So my message for you is, don't react instant. Show some compassion. Don't hold on. Instead, move on. This is your life. You make the best choice. Thank you.
Very nice, Yash. And stay here. We have a question for you from author Sherry.
Yash, bete, aapki age kitni hai?
Sir, 15.
15. Gaurav, jara screen hatao apni. Yash se baat karni hai mereko. Bete, aapne preparation kara tha speech ko?
Yes, sir.
Achha, aur aap thoda sa haklate bhi ho? हाँ तो आपके लिए मेरी बात ध्यान से सुनना आप जो बोलने जा रहा हूँ मैं ठीक है ये आपकी लाइफ चेंज कर देगी ठीक है आपने जब भी स्पीकिंग करनी है पब्लिक स्पीकिंग करनी है लोगों के सामने बोलना है तो आपने बिल्कुल रिलैक्स रहना है बिल्कुल रिलैक्स आपको ऐसी लाइफ में क्या चीज करनी होती है या आप ऐसी कौन सी चीज करते हो जिससे आपको रिलैक्स फील होता है पूछ रहा हूँ आपसे मैं ठीक है तो आपने इसको गेम बनाना है ये स्टेट ऑफ माइंड से होगा बेटे ठीक है मेंटल स्टेट ऑफ माइंड होता है जो हमारा माइंडसेट होता है उससे आपने इसको बिल्कुल रिलैक्स वे में करना है नहीं तो आपकी स्पीकिंग नर्वसनेस में कन्वर्ट हो जाएगी ठीक है जो हो रही थी थोड़ी थोड़ी ठीक है अभी आपकी बहुत सही एज है कि आपको किसी ने टोक दिया ठीक है भगवान मेरे थ्रू बुलवा रहा है आपको तो आपने ये ध्यान रखना है बेटे कि आपने जब भी स्पीकिंग करनी है किसी तरह की नर्वस ना आए उसके लिए रिलैक्स वे में बात करना है और एक बात और ध्यान रखना कंपटीशन जीतने के लिए कभी मत आना वरना हमेशा हारोगे कंपटीशन में अपना बेस्ट करने के लिए आना तो हमेशा जीतोगे समझ में आई बात
यस सर
ठीक है ये एटीट्यूड थोड़ा सा स्वाइप कर लो बस ये दो चीजें याद रखना कौन कौन सी दो चीजें रिपीट करो क्या समझाया मैंने भी आपको
सर ये रिलैक्स होके बोलूं
बिल्कुल रिलैक्स होके
जीतने के लिए ना
बस और मम्मी से जैसे बात करते हो ना घर में मम्मी खाना डाल दो मम्मी कहाँ जा रहे हो मार्केट जा रहे हो मुझे आपके साथ चलना है बिल्कुल रिलैक्स में बात करनी है ठीक है आपका ये हकलाना भी हट जाएगा कॉन्शियस नहीं होना इस पे क्योंकि जैसे ही आप कॉन्शियस हो रहे हो ना जो ब्रेन है ना बेटे हमारा वो ब्रेन आपकी कॉन्शियसनेस पे जा रहा है, स्पीकिंग से हट गया। तो जब कॉन्शियसनेस पे ब्रेन जा रहा है स्पीकिंग से हट गया, तो स्पीकिंग तो नीचे आएगी ना।
यस सर।
क्योंकि कॉन्शियसनेस आपकी सर नर्वसनेस पे चली गई सारी।
यस सर।
ठीक है, तो नर्वसनेस को ज्यादा तबज्जुब नहीं देना, हकलाना अपने आप हट जाएगा आपका धीरे धीरे। और जो आपकी रेट ऑफ स्पीच है वो बिल्कुल ठीक है, ठीक है, बस उसको बैलेंस करके चलना है, रिलैक्स करना है बस। ठीक है, बोलने का तरीका ठीक है,
ठीक है,
बाकी फर्दर और है ना, और कुछ चीजें जो भी होंगी दिमाग में कभी आएंगे तो बता दूंगा आपको, बट ये ध्यान रखना आपने दो तीन चीजें।
ओके सर, श्योर सर,
गॉड ब्लेस यू।
थैंक यू सर।
एंड कैन आई से थैंक यू टू शेरी भाई फॉर शेयरिंग ऑल दिस। थैंक यू, आई आल्सो लर्नड।
माय प्लेजर सर।
All right, thank you so much for sharing this knowledge of wisdom. What a fantastic feedback live on this event. Very, very nice and really commendable. And dosto, let's move on to our next speaker. We have Lipsa Rani Raut from Odisha. And the topic is self-belief make you success. Over to you, Lipsa.
Hello, everyone. I hope everyone is doing well. Yes. So, यहाँ पे आप लोग में से कितना जन टॉयज के साथ खेल मतलब खेलते हैं, बात करते हैं? कैन प्लीज यूज योर चैट बॉक्स एंड रिप्लाई यस और नो। एंड आई कैन सी हियर गौरव, सेरी सर एंड सुभाष सर, लाइक इस एज में टॉयज के साथ खेलना और इस एज में उसके साथ बात करना, बट आई लव टॉयज, यू नो। टिक टिक टिक, देखो ये कौन है, एक छोटी सी गुड़िया है जो अभी बड़ी हो गई है, मैं तो रोज उसके साथ बात करती हूँ। चलो सुनते हैं, ये जब छोटी थी ना, लोगों के साथ बात करना, सोशल वर्क में इन्वॉल्व होना और लोगों को सारे न्यू क्रिएटिवनेस आइडिया शेयर करने में बहुत पसंद करती थी। एंड यू नो ये सारी चीज उसको बहुत अच्छा लग रहा था, लोग भी उसको अच्छा से सुन रहे थे। बस बंद करो, बहुत हो गया, ये लड़की को ये सारी चीज शोभा नहीं करता है बोलना ये करना। जैसे जसप्रीत ने बोला कि हमारे सोसाइटी में सब माइंड फिक्स कर लेते हैं लड़की के लिए, वैसे ही कुछ आपस पीछे से किसने आपने बोला था, बोल रही थी उनके लिए। बट आप लोग डर गए, डरना नहीं है, हिम्मत रखना है। होल नाइट उसने रोई थी, इसलिए नहीं कि वो वीक है, इसलिए कि आगे उसको जाना था। तो ऐसे ही टेंथ का एग्जाम था, तो टेंथ के एग्जाम में एक दो महीना पहले स्कूल छुट्टी हो जाता है, राइट। तो क्या हुआ ना, इसका जो एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज का जो टीचर है घर आए थे, तो मम्मी ने उसे अच्छा सा अदरक वाली चाय दी, मैम का मूड फ्रेश हो गया, सोचे कि मतलब माहौल अच्छा है, चलो बात कर लेते हैं। तो एक इको फ्रेंड्स रहता है, एक स्टेट लेवल डिबेट कंपटीशन एवरी ईयर में वो लड़की पार्टिसिपेट कर रही थी स्कूल के लिए और कुछ ना कुछ पोजीशन ला रही। तो लास्ट ईयर है ये, क्यों ना ट्राई करते। अचानक मम्मी से आ गया कि एग्जाम का टाइम है, मैम ये सब में मत डालिए, नेक्स्ट ईयर से तो किसी दूसरे को जाना है, उसको पार्टिसिपेट करा लीजिए। फिर से पीछे से एक आवाज आया, ये बोलने से क्या मिलेगा, कैरियर बनाओ, 90% मार्क लाओ, पढ़ाई करो। मैम ने चाय पी के जितना खुश थे उतना दुखी हो गए। फिर भी लड़की ने एक ही वार्ड बोले कि मैम आप जाइए, मैं पहुंच जाऊंगी। फिर भी मैम को डाउट था, अगर नहीं आएगी तो स्कूल का नाम बदनाम हो जाएगा। तो 3 days आफ्टर जो इवेंट था थी वहां पे, झूठ बोला घर पे भी, मैं फ्रेंड के घर में पढ़ाई करने जा रही हूँ, बिलीव मी। वो विदाउट एनी प्रिपेरेशन में फर्स्ट होके आई थी। दिस इज हियर द सर्टिफिकेट ऑफ 2006। This is none other than me. I am unique girl, Lipsa. आप लोग सोच रहे होंगे कि इतना अच्छा बोल रही थी तो अभी तो कुछ ना कुछ मतलब पब्लिक स्पीकर की इवेंट शो होस्टिंग कुछ ना कुछ में मतलब करियर बन गई होगी, बट नो, द 14 years आफ्टर 10th इट्स लाइक यू नो, मैं अच्छा करियर बैंक में एक असिस्टेंट मैनेजर में थी, बट अंदर से जो फीलिंग था ना, जैसे शेरी सर ने बोले थे कि स्पीक बाय योर हार्ट, भाई मेरा पैशन कुछ अलग था, मैं कुछ अलग लाइन में आ गई, तो वो अंदर से कुछ मुझे ये कर रहा था। आई वॉज लाइक यू नो, जितना जोर से मैं बात कर रही थी उतना डबल रेटेड मैं पैरालाइज हो गई थी, लाइक फ्रॉम माई माइंड आई वॉज कम्प्लीटली साइलेंट। आई एम सर्चिंग फॉर द मेंटर, सर्चिंग फॉर समथिंग लाइक आई विल गो बाय माई पैशन। एंड आई वुड से कि लॉकडाउन, थैंक्स टू लॉकडाउन 2020 एंड दिस पर्सन ऑथर शेरी सर, यू नो, was completely changed from my mindset. And आज मैं आप लोग के सामने बोल पा रही हूँ, ये मेरे लिए बहुत बड़ी बात है। मैं इतना बोल नहीं पाती हूँ। इस रिमेम्बर होगा शेरी सर को, उनका एक कोचिंग सेशन में मैं बोलने से पहले ऐसे वाइब्रेशन कर रही थी और रो रही थी, बट नाउ आई एम आउट ऑफ दिस। एक गुड न्यूज है शेरी सर के लिए कि मैंने एक ओडिया टॉक बोल के एक स्टार्ट किया हूँ उड़ीसा में, जैसे कि पब्लिक स्पीकिंग 0% इन ओडिशा, ओनली चांस फॉर द सेलिब्रिटीज। एंड उसमें 50 प्लस स्पीकर अराउंड द वर्ल्ड ज्वाइन किए हैं और मैं उनको साथ सेशन कर रही हूँ. एंड और एक गुड न्यूज है कि स्टार्टअप उड़ीसा 2020 का जो प्लान था यूथ कोला 2020 रिसेंटली लास्ट टू डेज पहले मैंने सबमिट किए हैं. एंड सबके और मुझे एजुकेशन डिपार्टमेंट से भी आया ये बहुत बड़ी स्टार्ट है. तो मुझे लग रहा है आगे में जो सिरिसर का मिशन में भी ज्वाइन करके सक्सेसफुल कर पाऊंगी. और मुझे दो चीज बहुत पसंद लगता है, वो है ये दो चीज, सेल्फ बिलीफ, पैशन एंड करेज. अगर आप उसमें ध्यान दोगे जिंदगी में सक्सेस में जरूर पहुंच जाओगे. मुझे गाना सुनना पसंद है, गाना याद नहीं रहता है, सॉरी बट मैं दिख के बोलूंगी. ए मत कहो खुदा से मेरी मुश्किलें बड़ी है, ए मुश्किलें से कह दो मेरा खुदा बड़ी है. आती है अंधिया तो कर उनको खैर मकदम, तूफा से ही तो लड़नी है, खुदा ने तुझे चढ़ाए. दिस थ्री लाइन, थ्री सेंटेंस, पैशन, courage and self-belief. Remember it. Thank you.
Wow, you are super awesome. Very, very nice. Really commendable. The way you have used the props and the previous speaker example to speak. Very, very nice. Can I ask author Sherry to say a few words? This is really amazing.
इस लड़की की कहानी बड़ी इंस्पायरिंग है गौरव. पता नहीं पब्लिकली मैं ऐसे बोलू ना बोलू, लड़की है ना पता नहीं कोई कैसे ले लेता है.
सर मैंने फाइट करने के लिए तैयार हूँ आपके.
ये देखो ये इस बिटिया का कॉन्फिडेंस देखो, कहाँ सातवें आसमान को छुआ पड़ा है. छा जाएगी, चक दे फट्टे, पंजाबी में बोलते हैं ना चक दे फट्टे, उड़ीसा में चक दे फट्टे.
मैंने फोटो अच्छे से नहीं बना पाई, आई थॉट की जेरॉक्स ले लूंगी बट पॉसिबल नहीं हो पाया.
नहीं मैं मैंने तो बहुत माइंड करा, मैं तुम्हारी क्लास लूंगा, अभी ठहर जाओ जरा, इवेंट खत्म हो रहे तो फिर मैं तुम्हें बताता हूँ. गॉड ब्लेस यू, कीप स्माइलिंग लाइक दिस एंड कीप ग्रोइंग. और जो डिसीजन ले लिया है ना और वो डिसीजन पे आगे बढ़ जाओ, अब कुछ नहीं रोकेगा. यू आर अनस्टॉपेबल नाउ, आगे बढ़ो. गॉड ब्लेस यू.
वेरी नाइस, सो स्वीट, लवली. आई एम रियली गेटिंग इमोशनल विद ऑल दिस अमेजिंग परफॉर्मेंसेस गाइस. एंड लेट्स इनवाइट आवर वेरी नेक्स्ट स्पीकर. वी हैव Pratiksha Parande from Mumbai. The topic is artificial intelligence. Interesting. So over to you, Pratiksha. And your time starts now.
Yes. Good morning, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Pratiksha Parande, and I will be speaking about artificial intelligence. Interesting, right? The definition of artificial intelligence, according to Google, is the theory and development of computer systems that are able to perform tasks that normally require human intelligence, such as visual perception, decision making, speech recognition, and translation between languages. So, let's see how it works. Hey Google, can you tell me who's the father of artificial intelligence? From Siri to self-driving cars, artificial intelligence has grown up. Science fiction often portrays AI as robots with human-like characteristics. It's really amazing how the power of AI has grown. Just think, not long ago, robots could do walk. Now they can do backflips. Not long ago, AI couldn't do face recognition. Now it can generate fake faces. So please be careful, everybody. Most researchers agree that artificial intelligence is unlikely to exhibit human emotions, such as love or hate, and that there is no need to expect AI to become intentionally benevolent or malevolent. Instead, when considering how AI might become a risk, experts think two scenarios. The first scenario would be AI is programmed to do something devastating. Autonomous weapons are artificial intelligence systems that are programmed to kill. In the hands of the wrong person, these weapons could cause mass casualties. The second scenario would be AI is programmed to do something beneficial, but its method for achieving its goal is destructive. For example, if you have an obedient intelligent car which will take you to the airport as fast as possible, it might get you there chased by helicopters, cars, trees, and whatnot, doing not what you wanted but literally what you asked for. There are controversies where the world's leading expert that are AI's future impact on the job market, whether this will lead to an intelligent explosion, and whether this is something we should welcome or fear. But there are many examples of boring pseudo controversies caused by people misunderstanding. Let's clear some of the common myths of AI today. The very first myth of AI is robot taking place of humans at workplaces. But the fact is, misaligned intelligence is the main concern. It needs no body, but an internet connection. The second myth of all time is AI cannot control humans. Do you really think so? The fact is, we human intelligence controls the artificial intelligence. That is, we control the trigger by being smart. And most favorite myth of all time is super intelligent is by 21st century is inevitable and just years away. It may take that long or centuries or decades, but you never know when it happens. It may take that long to make it safe. The president of Future of Life Institute, Max Tegmark, has said, everything we love about civilization is a product of intelligence.
1 minute left.
So amplifying our human intelligence with artificial intelligence has the potential to flourish civilization like never before, as long as we manage to keep the technology beneficial. Thank you.
Very nice, Pratiksha. Very, very nice. And next we have is Swara Shettigar from Mumbai. And the topic is the myth of Sisyphus. So over to you.
Thank you. Good morning, everybody. Good afternoon, everybody. I am Swara from Pechan. What? Wondering about the stone and my reason for holding it? Well, there are two reasons. Firstly, I am nervous. Secondly, I'm here to tell you a story about how this stone changed the lives of two people. I am the second person. Who is the first? Sisyphus. He was the king of Corinth in ancient Greece, known for deception and a peculiar punishment that he faced. He was known for deceiving the great gods, even the Greek god Zeus. He spared no one. Even the god of death got trapped in his lies. He dodged death in the best possible way, but he had to face his consequences someday. So the frustrated Greek gods decided to trap him into an eternal punishment. He was asked to take a boulder up a hill. But every time he was about to reach the top, the boulder would roll down and taunt all his efforts. He had to repeat this till eternity, and this became his never-ending punishment for skipping death. However, for those who think he finally lost, I have something to tell you. His story then is actually our story today. Even before dictators, rulers, and fascists took over, mythology had witnessed tyranny in its purest form through Sisyphus. A devious anarchist, a reckless ruler, a con artist known for deceiving the Greek gods of life and death. He mocked life like that man next door mocking his third wife. The paragon of trials to survive one extra minute, earn one extra dollar, fool one extra customer, and abuse one extra woman. The list went on and on, but he always found his way out. Made with blocks of arrogance and intellect, he proved to be that spoiled upper-class boy by birth. In spite of a decorated life, he always seemed dejected. With a hustling job and boring rides and a screaming mom and a dominating wife. His mind was dying, yet he didn't stop lying. All his life, for love he dared, but no one really cared. Poor boy Sisyphus went against the divine system. And surprised he got treated like that leftist who questioned capitalism. He got treated at his will and was asked to take the boulder up the hill. This was his final exam, the toughest one to pass. Similar to the stages of paper revaluation, he was trapped in a clutch of time. Unable to love, unable to fly, poor boy Sisyphus took the boulder up each time, only to see it rolling by. Yet angry but determined, he kept on climbing in spite of his vice. But he couldn't pause, neither could the rock. He knew his destiny along with his scars, but the art of deception boiled in his blood. However, today, Sisyphus smiles as the boulder rolls down. After years of deadlock, he had found peace again. The gods of time had lost one more round while Sisyphus smiles at his healing wound. On asking the boulder about its humiliating defeat, it replied, Sisyphus had died, but the human in him survives. This, my friends, is the reason why I'm holding this stone today. We ridicule our boring and mundane struggles and criticize our fate. However, humans are the only living beings that can embrace this struggle and evolve out of it. This boring routine is nothing but a test. Our test to defy fate or collapse under it. No matter how heavy things are, it is up to you to make the best of it. This stone is your challenge. You either hold it with a heavy heart or juggle it and let it pass. Thank you.
Very nice, Swara. And dosto, next we have is Mr. Rajiv Bangari from New Delhi. And his topic is power of words. Over to you, Rajiv ji. Your time starts now.
Good afternoon, esteemed jury and my dear friends. This topic is very close to my heart because it totally changed my life. And because of that, I'm presently over here. I was totally an underconfident guy during my school and college days. I still remember. I love people going on to dais and speaking convincingly. I always wanted to be there, but I always sat on the benches of the audience. In the ninth standard, I mustered the courage and went to my housemaster and said that I will present a news tomorrow. On the day of performance, I didn't turn up to the school, stayed at home and making a plea that I'm having fever. My school and college life path, I never performed because deep inside myself, I was having a self-talk that I can't. There is nothing I can do. And more importantly, I am not worthwhile. I got married. The lady who came in my life changed my life because she totally altered my world. She said, change your I can't with I can. Change your there is nothing I can do with I will look for the alternative and work. Replace this I am not worthwhile with that I am perfect. I am whole and complete. There was no looking back since then. Subsequently, there was my office function in which both of us participated. She sang a beautiful song and I recited a poem. Subsequently, I participated in various talk shows. This is a clip of 2019 MS Talks convention held at Gurugram, where I went initially as an audience, then participated as a speaker. During this COVID-19 pandemic, I participated in various digital platforms. And this is one of the click of a program where I speak on mental and emotional well-being during COVID-19 pandemic as a leadership coach. Friends, the words changed my life. It can change the life of everyone. I tell you how it is. Gautam Buddha, when stopped by Dakung Lima, said two powerful sentences which changed the life of Dakung Lima. And he said, I have stopped. When you will stop, this struck the heart of Dakung Lima and he changed his life and he became his biggest disciple. Swami Vivekananda during the World Religious Conference said powerful beginning and said, my dear brothers and sisters, there was a plot, thunderous applause, and it subsided after 2 minutes because his words were straight from your heart, from his heart. And if we blend our word with our heart, it's make an angelic and divine feeling. My dear friend, in the end, I will say, your thoughts become reality through your words. So what we say basically reflect our being. That is to say, what we say that we are. So by constant recognizing the power of words, we can change our being the way I did, from an underconfident speaker to a confident speaker. Now I can address any. My dear friend, in the end, I appeal and urge you, all you guys, the publishing community, the world, be your voice. Inspire others in this pandemic. Create a life, create a meaningful society in which everyone being irrespective of caste are holding their hands together to create a beautiful and meaningful society, which we always aspire for. Finally, and I conclude and take a cue from Stephen Covey's book, which says, and I quote, "Sow your words, shower your words, propagate that message, and reap your destiny." Thank you very much.
Very nice, Rajiv ji. And next we have is Sur Khurana from New Delhi. And the topic is why. Why public speaking? Over to you, sir. Your time starts now.
Hi, hello, hi GJ. Thank you for the introduction. Lovely audience here. So my time starts right here. I know. So I have a topic of public speaking. I know this is like the elephant in the room. Let me address that first. Okay, I am on the platform of public speaking, talking on the topic of public speaking in front of the people who are already gurus and my mentor in the forum of public speaking. And that's because I am a public speaking enthusiast myself. So whatever I have to share today comes from my own practices and comes from my own experience. So if I please can look away from the lens for a little while and check out my screen and see how many people are actually wearing glasses. GJ is one of them. Okay, many other people, right? Rohan Anand is one of them. Sirish sir is one of them. Rajiv sir, I catch you. Yeah. So there are many people who are using this particular thing. I mean, if I actually can ask each one of you, why do you are actually using this glasses, pair of glasses for yourself? You may come up with reasons like, okay, I have a farsightedness issues, or probably such as for me, I'm using it for the purpose of able to look at my screen for longer hours and hence just blur the harsh light. But the reason, the purpose behind using this tool is to actually aid our eyesight, actually get a clarity in our vision. So when I use this as a tool for my eyes, this is actually working as a catalyst. And public speaking is nothing but a catalyst to your already present skill set. And that's what I'm going to talk about today here. Since I actually had the pleasure of going for a little trip in Rishikesh, I ended up learning that public speaking is not just a thing that you use on the stage, but it is something that you end up using in many areas of your life. Let me go by these. The first one is this one. You are a person who has such a life lessons lived behind you. You have your own experiences. You have your own life lessons as your own wisdom, right? Your own USP. So when you are able to use the art of communication as a tool for yourself, you can actually embark in conversations that strive you to go harder in your own subject. You as a person have your life lessons as your experiences, but the moment you share with the right person, with the like-minded audience, you not only have the limited perspective which you had earlier, you're able to enlarge the horizon around it. You're able to grow yourself in that subject even more. Now, moving on to this reason number two, why I believe that public speaking is the need of the hour. So since I was on a trip in Rishikesh, trust me, it was such a big blessing for me that I was able to really be, you know, depth with the art of communication and ask the right question to the right people at the right time. So I was having that luck by my side to sit among an audience where this was an influencer, a yoga expert, and somebody who has an era of information when it comes to mindfulness. And that is a subject. And this is what I practice as a coach for myself. If I was not efficient when it comes to public speaking or able to ask the right question at the right time, I would have lost the opportunity to have the in-depth knowledge shared from the other side of the world. Now, when you are actually having public speaking skills set on your side, in your kitty, you're not just talking, you're actually communicating to connect. Now you're co-creating. Now you're co-creating such conversations that is not only going to add value to the other person's life, but also add value to your own life, to your own present information as of now. When you co-create, you expand your network, you actually make meaningful relationships, like-minded people, quality bonds in your life. Now moving on to the reason number three. This one is very personal to me. The reason why I actually thought that public speaking has to be my thing, has to be my thing. That's because I, as a little schoolgirl, when I used to stand in my assembly, I really used to look up to the thought of the day. Why? Because I knew A square plus B square is equal to C square is not really going to help me in my life skills. I do want to learn more about the real information about life, right? And that thought of the day helped me work through that. Now, when I actually see myself working in the same field, I see that public speaking has given me that chance to bring that pool of information for myself to make myself as a thought leader, somebody who can bring that change in the society. We all expect the change in the output. We are not really putting the change in the input. So this is my take. This is my little steps towards bringing that change in my own set of reality by embarking in the public speaking community, by learning the art of communication. And as I believe, we all have a great purpose as human existence on this planet, not to live, but to live a life of significance. And art of communication brings you that life of communication. Thank you so much, everyone, for listening me out here. I bring back Gigi on the board. Bye.
Wow, sir. Amazing energy you got. Very, very nice. Kudos to that. And dosto, 3 p.m. is the time of the results announcement. And there's a fantastic surprise is coming your way. All you wonderful विनर्स रिजल्ट्स हम 3 बजे बताने वाले हैं जूम आईडी की डिटेल्स आपके चैट रूम पे आ गई हैं प्लीज से दैट एंड इट्स टाइम टू कॉल अप ऑन अवर वेरी नेक्स्ट स्पीकर वी हैव मिस्टर रोहन आनंद फ्रॉम प्रयागराज टॉपिक इज द गुड इनिशिएटिव सो ओवर टू यू रोहन ऑल द बेस्ट एंड योर टाइम स्टार्ट्स नाउ
टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेल अ स्टोरी दैट इज द गुड इनिशिएटिव वंस अपॉन अ टाइम देयर लिव्ड अ ग्रेट किंग नेम्ड मयूर He was a very wise and a just ruler of that time. He confronted many obstacles to make his kingdom one of the best kingdoms of India. He was applauded by his people for his good initiatives. He introduced many rules for the welfare of his people. But one thing that troubled his mind was his people's laziness. His people were very lazy. They didn't used to join the army because of laziness. And thus, the army became very weak. Its strength also died down. This was a matter of major concern for the king and the kingdom too, because the king also lost 2 territories, which played a major role in the contribution of the kingdom. So as to solve this problem, the king arranged a meeting with his council of ministers. Many ministers came and many suggestions they gave. But none of them were appropriate for the king. So he called his wisest minister to give a wonderful suggestion. The minister said to put a big stone on the path leading to the kingdom and then hiding behind a tree. The king found this appropriate and did this. After hiding behind the tree, the king said that now I will look after that what happens after. The first person to come was Girdhar, a carpenter. So let's say this as the stone and this as Girdhar. He was in haste and got stumbled against the stone. He fell down and got a bad hurt. He said that the picture of the safety of the people is very obscene. I am very angry at the king's guards and the king too. Then he went away. Then the second person to come was a rich merchant. He was sitting on a bullock cart. So let's say this as the merchant. Suppose he's sitting on a bullock cart. When he saw the stone, he ordered his driver to take a different route and went away. The king was very disappointed to see that. He said that my people are very asinine. They can't even remove the stone from the path. He almost lost all his hope, but he stood for a while and saw that a boy is coming. He was a 12 years old boy. He thought that he seemed to be a beacon light of hope for the king because the children were the future of the nation and they had the capabilities of problem solving, decision making, critical thinking, and taking initiatives. When the boy saw the stone, he started removing the stone away and finally was successful in doing that. The king was very happy to see that, and he stepped out and praised him a lot. And as a prize, he gave some gold coins to the boy and praised him publicly also. Then after, the people of the kingdom realized their mistake. They learned a strong lesson from the boy. They started joining the army, and the army became very strong, so to confront the attacks led by the rival kingdoms. Then the king quickly ordered his army to head towards the lost territories and finally was successful in regaining them all. He made mind to capture more territory, more new territories of other kingdoms, so as to expand his kingdom. So this story is a message to the society of taking initiatives. And taking initiatives is a foundation of problem solving, decision making, and critical thinking. And also, opportunity comes and goes off. So we should explore our opportunity and make the best use of that. And there is also a proverb said that a miss is as good as a mile. It means that if we miss out our opportunities, it can push us back and it can be very harmful to us. So with this, I would like to rest my speech. Thank you.
Very nice, Rohan. And can I ask Priyanka Behel to say a few words?
Thank you so much. I would say the words for everyone rather, instead of picking up one speaker, because this has been a complete inspiring journey. So many thoughts, such young orators, such great clarity, so many of transformation journeys of people who are just giving me goosebumps. Like Shruti's personally, I really got like goosebumps when she really connected the entire story with so much flawlessness, and Akshay being one of the, you know, greatest. Then we had Ashwin. I mean, I really go flow with the flow. I mean, the people bring so much of content, such great knowledge. I mean, I'm just feeling so like, you know, in that complete humbleness, breathing in gratitude that I have a chance to witness this entire show. So kudos, Author Sherry, you are really bringing hope, you know, you are really bringing transformation, and this platform is really helping all of us to learn and grow. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Pearl Behel, for your knowledge and your inputs. And dosto, so much knowledge, wisdom, inspiration, sharing, learnings is happening in the house. So all you are the chosen ones. And you can, you know, pat on your back that we all are participating here. We are able to contribute in some way we can, because all your words, sentences are touching somewhere in people's heart. So time is for the next speaker. We have Aishanya Ranjan from Rajkot, and topic is my life experience with books. Aishanya, over to you, and all the best.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Namaste, everybody. I'm Aishanya Ranjan. Today, I'm going to share my life's experience about books and how it played a vital role in my day-to-day life. This is a book? No, not at all. This is not only a book, but a great source of inspiration. This is an ocean of knowledge. Mentor, your answer key to all your problems. This is your school of life skills. It helps you survive all odds of life and helps you to take the correct decision whenever you are stuck. When I was as young as 3 years old, I was introduced to the world of books by my mother. Reason? I was a hyperactive kid. I could not sit still at one place for more than a couple of seconds. The second I was out of my mother's eyesight, and everything would be on the floor, totally messed up. And my mother used to say, "Nazar hati, durghatna ghati." So books with attractive pictures was introduced to me. I was fascinated towards books and would read and see the stories through pictures. I would sit with it for longer time now. This solved half of my mother's problems. So this is how it started. Slowly, I got introduced to many other informative books, as encyclopedia, books about amazing facts, test books, etc. And I showed a great interest in all of them. This is how I inculcated the habit of reading in me. My mom was happier than before because there was less distraction at home now and I asked much lesser questions. But the problem started when I grew a bit more and started to mingle more with the outside world. I started making more friends and now I had a social life of my own. I went through victory and failure. I went through appreciation and criticism. All of these would hurt me every day. I had thousands of questions in my mind, but answer to none. My mom always tried to guide me towards the correct path. She used to counsel me, but I hardly ever agreed with her. I thought, kitna lecture deti hai. Isko kya pata hamari life mein kitni difficulty hai. Kitna tension hamari life mein. School life mein, teacher expectations high, tension. Good marks lane ka tension. Dost se jhagda hua, to tension. Friends ki party mein best dikhne ka tension. हर सब्जेक्ट में हाईएस्ट मार्क्स लाने से हेल्दी फूड खाने तक टेंशन ही टेंशन. देयर वाज अ टोटल स्ट्रगल कंफ्यूजन एंड टैसल बिटवीन माय माइंड एंड सोल. दैट्स व्हेन माय मदर इंट्रोड्यूस्ड रिलीजियस बुक्स टू मी टू एनहांस स्पिरिचुअल एंड कल्चरल वैल्यूज इन मी. रीडिंग एंड नोइंग मोर अबाउट दीज बुक्स एक्चुअली हेल्प मी टू लुक एवरी सिचुएशन डिफरेंटली. नाउ आई बिकेम मोर कंसिडरेट towards others and their emotions. I understood that both of us can have a different point of views, yet both can be correct. Difference of opinion does not mean that someone is against us. It only means that he or she is looking things differently. This solved a lot of my relationship and social problems. I became less judgmental about others now. I learned that life is an ongoing process and every situation is a learning experience. I understood that the greatest enemy of ours are not the people around us, but the fear inside us. What we think is what we become. The brain is our boss. I started to be more thankful for what I have rather than to complain for what I don't have. I understood that we do not work to make others happy or to prove ourselves to others. We work to learn every day. It's okay to make mistakes. It's absolutely okay to fall. But what matters is that we rise up again with much more determination, hard work, and proactiveness. I understood that getting gold medals in all walks of life is not our ultimate goal. I'm aware I may not be the best, but I'm continuously trying to improve myself. And with each passing day, I'm trying to become a better version of myself. Thank you.
So sweet. Very, very nice, Aishanya. And next we have is Mr. Rajiv Bagga from Ahmedabad. Rajiv ji, I think nahi hai. Rajiv 1, Rajiv 2, Rajiv 3. Okay. Let's move on to the next one. Next we have is Mr. Shailesh Kumar from Prayagraj. The topic is My Destiny is My Choice. Yes, please unmute yourself, Shailesh ji. Okay, I think Shailesh ji is also not here. So next we have is Ankit Srivastav from Kanpur. And his topic is Defeat Orally, glossophobia. Interesting. Over to you, Ankit ji. Your time starts now.
Good afternoon to all the judges and participants. Today, I'll be speaking on defeat thoroughly glossophobia. I'm sure that many of you have gone through the phase of glossophobia, a complex word with a complex meaning. But during my secondary school days, I was a very shy boy when it comes to interact with the people. But slowly and gradually, as I was growing up, I started becoming an extrovert who likes to mingle with the people. One day, during an assembly, I was attentively observing the person who was speaking. And earlier, it seemed to me as a piece of cake, but it was not. The first step in learning this was gathering some information about public speaking. Those who have been familiar to public speaking They should recognize it easily. A microphone. Yes, a microphone. Speaking in front of an audience or speaking with a mic have equal fear when we are delivering something. A mic can be a handheld, a corner mic, but it should be a mic. The word mic makes the fear out of our tremble. One day when I was going to school, so I thought that why I should not share my experience with others, what I've learned till now. So the first time when I thought to share my experience, I started it with my classmates. In the starting, they were seeming very surprised that how I have overcome my fear of public speaking. But slowly and gradually, as I was innovating, as I was inputting them more and more about the knowledge that I've gained of public speaking, they were surprised. They were amazed at how I have overcome. So after a few days, when we all were gathered, then at that time, I and some of my friends started giving each other easy and simple topics to speak on. But slowly and gradually, as we were a beginners in the public speaking skill, so it was a bit hard job for us to express our views on different topics and how to express it in an efficient manner and with good voice modulation. So after that, after lots of hard work and immense dedication, after months of hard work, we all were now prepared to give good speeches on different topics to impress people with our knowledge, with our skill, with our habit of impressing others. Then after that, we thought that are we the only one who are facing the problem of public speaking or glossophobia? No, not at all. Absolutely not. So we thought, why not to share our experience and aware others also about public speaking skills? As in India, there are more than 1.3 million people. So it was a very hard job for us to aware everyone. So we started it with awaring the people of our locality. In the starting, it was a bit hard job for us to aware others because in India, the people don't take public speaking as a profession, or they don't take it as a serious thing or on a serious note. But slowly and gradually, as you were awaring them, the more we are wearing them, the more they were curious about the things that we have learned till now. So it was a bit hard job for us in the starting, but slowly and gradually, as in the starting, we were giving them easy topics to speak on. They were some of them were very curious about speaking and some of them were not. So we understood that it's not an easy job, not at all, to make all the people understand the importance of public speaking. But slowly and gradually, somehow we were managed to make them overcome the fear of public speaking. And after that, the persons who were not curious, we showed them what are the after effects, what are the things that can happen if we are not able to express our views in front of anyone, in front of an audience. I still remember when the first time I faced the audience, it was a very terrible experience. I can't imagine it. It was really very terrible. But after that, I understood that it's a learn going process. It's an ongoing process. So we have to learn it a bit by bit. We can't just learn it as quickly as anything else. So it was a very hard job for me to become a public speaker at an early age. But somehow, after months of hard work and immense dedication, I was able to perform on different platforms and I was able to overcome the fear of public speaking. And I thought, why not to share my experience with others and help them overcome the fear of public speaking? The second step in this was facing the audience. And it was a very hard job for me. Thank you.
All right. Very nice, Ankit. And so next we have is Mr. Shailesh Kumar from Prayagraj. His topic is My Destiny is My Choice. Shailesh, your time starts now.
किस्मत लिखने वाले को भगवान कहते हैं और इसे हकीकत में बदलने वाले को इंसान कहते हैं. वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून जूरीज एंड ऑल डियर माय पार्टिसिपेंट्स. आई एम शैलेश फ्रॉम प्रयागराज. कहते हैं किस्मत हम ऊपर वाले से लिखवा कर लाते हैं, पर क्या सच में हमारी किस्मत वही लिखता है या हम स्वयं अपनी किस्मत को लिखते हैं? तो आइए इसे हम एक छोटी सी स्टोरी के द्वारा समझते हैं. बिहार के एक छोटे से गांव में एक गरीब घर में एक लड़का पैदा होता है। उसके माँ बाप अशिक्षित होने कारण उसके घर में पढ़ाई लिखाई का माहौल नहीं है और पढ़ाई क्या चीज़ होती है उसे कुछ पता नहीं है। बस उसे बस इतना ही है खेलना कूदना और माँ बाप के साथ जो काम है उसमें हाथ बटाना। कुछ दिन के बाद उस लड़के का दोस्ती गांव के ही एक टीचर के बेटे से होती है। वह टीचर का बेटा उससे कहता है कि हम सब चलें वैसे स्कूल में चलें जहाँ पे खाने और पढ़ने के लिए मिलता है। वह लड़का राजी हो जाता है और इसके लिए अपने माँ बाप को भी राजी कर लेता है। उसके बाद उसकी पढ़ाई धीरे धीरे इम्प्रूव करने लगती है और बस उसकी दोस्ती धीरे धीरे किताबों से हो जाती है और उसके अदम साहस और लगन से उसकी जर्नी आगे बढ़ते जाती है। आगे बढ़ते बढ़ते वो एक मुकाम हासिल करता है और मुकाम हासिल करके एक इंडिया के प्रतिष्ठित जो पेट्रोलियम कंपनी है इंडियन ऑयल कॉरपोरेशन उसमें वो अभी इस समय कार्य कर रहा है और वो कोई नहीं स्वयं मैं शैलेश कुमार जो इलाहाबाद प्रयागराज से हूँ। इसका तो ऐसा नहीं कि सिर्फ मैंने मेहनत की तो मैं कुछ बन पाया, इसके लिए मेरे साथ अन्य लोगों ने मेरे साथ दिया जो मुझसे उम्मीद करते थे मेरे हम पे भरोसा करते थे मुझे हर पल सहयोग कर देते थे किसी भी रूप में चाहे वो आर्थिक हो भावनात्मक हो और मैं उनका सदा आभारी हूँ और आभारी रहूँगा। मैं अपने जीवन में कृतज्ञता को बहुत महत्व देता हूँ वो इसलिए कि अगर मैं कृतज्ञ हूँ रहूँगा तो हम दूसरों को उस नज़र से देख पाऊँगा और ये मुझे अंदर से रिलीफ देती है वो अंदर से शांत करती है जिससे मैं एक भरपूर अपनी ज़िंदगी को जी पाता हूँ। तो हमारी सोच हमारी नज़रिया हमारा अप्रोच हमारे दूसरों के प्रति व्यवहार हमारे कर्म हमारी भावनाएं इन सभी चीज़ों से हमारे भाग का निर्माण होता है क्योंकि हम स्वयं इन विचारों से बने होते हैं। कहते हैं हमारा मन प्रतिदिन लगभग 50,000 से 60,000 विचारें उत्पन्न करता है। अगर हम इन विचारों को श्रेष्ठ बना दें तो हमारे कर्म भी श्रेष्ठ बन जाएंगे फिर यही हमारे श्रेष्ठ कर्म हमारे एक श्रेष्ठ भाग को निर्माण करेगा। कहते हैं वक्त से लड़कर जो नसीब बदल दे उस वक्त से लड़कर जो नसीब बदल दे वही वह इंसान जो अपने तकदीर बदल दे। जो उलझे हुए को सुलझा दे उसे समझदार कहते हैं और जो सोए हुए को जगा दे उसे कलाकार कहते हैं। हमने कभी नहीं देखा ऐसे कलाकारों के जज्बे और लगन इसलिए एमएस टॉक के मिशन को सर झुका के करते हैं हम नमन। थैंक यू सो मच जूरीज ऑथर सरी सर एंड ऑल सपोर्टिंग टीम ऑफ एमएस टॉक। थैंक यू सो मच।
वेरी नाइस शैलेश जी। एंड दोस्तों लास्ट बट नॉट द लीस्ट वी हैव अ स्पीकर नेम इज आरुषि जाधव फ्रॉम मुंबई एंड द टॉपिक इज इंस्पायरिंग लाइफ ऑफ अपोला। Over to you, Arushi, and your time starts now.
Hello there. My name is Arushi Jadhav from Pehchan, and today I'm going to be talking about a very significant but often overlooked historical figure named Policarpa Salivarita. She was a young seamstress, that is someone who stitches clothes, who worked as a spy during the Colombian struggle of independence from the Spanish colonization, exactly the way us Indians were struggling to gain independence from the British colonization. Policarpa, or fondly known as La Pola, was born in Colombia to a large family. After smallpox ravaged her town and left her orphaned, she moved to Guados to live with her surviving family. Her new geographical location allowed La Pola to meet both the revolutionists, that is the Colombians who wanted independence, and the royalists, that is the Colombians who wanted the Spanish rule to stay. La Pola's family was on the side of the revolutionists during the war for independence. She took after her brothers and became an undercover revolutionist. At the young age of 13, La Pola took up work as a servant in many royalist homes. She worked as a seamstress, but her real job was to eavesdrop for information on the royalist plan. She went to visit captured revolutionists in prison, bringing them food and information. She persuaded young men drafted by the royalists to defect and join the rebellion. She sold revolutionist uniform while working in the homes of the royalists, and she coordinated supplies for the rebellion. It is important to note that while doing all of this, La Pola was just under 20 years old. Unfortunately, in the fall of 1817, her close confidant and fellow revolutionist Savarin was detained by the royalists and searched. On him were certain documents pertaining to La Pola's resistance, and a warrant was issued for her arrest. She also sacrificed herself by burning all the documents that would incriminate her revolutionist colleagues. Even in the face of a deathly arrest, she was courageous. She was then taken to prison, and in the November of 1817 was tried before the Council of War and found guilty of spying and treason. Her punishment? Death by firing squad. At dawn on November 18th, 1817, La Pola and her fellow prisoners were taken to Plaza Mayor in the middle of Bogota for a public execution. The public nature of this display was meant to send a message to the people of Bogota, the city. If you resist, this is what will happen to you. La Pola, however, made sure to send her own message. She refused to kneel in front of the Spanish soldiers, instead taunting them so loudly that drummers were ordered to increase their volume just to drown her voice out. When the time came for her final words, La Pola did not waste them. Shouting to the gathered crowd, she said, "Indolent people, how different your fate would be if you knew the price of freedom. But it is not too late. See that although I am young and a woman, I have enough courage to suffer this death and 1,000 more deaths. Do not forget this example." La Pola was executed by the firing squad. She was only 21 years old. La Pola's execution outraged the citizens and motivated many to join and strengthen the resistance to Spanish rule. Though many may have been reluctant to separate from Spain, after the selfless sacrifices made by La Pola and hundreds of others just like her were encouraged to fight for their own rights. In 1813, Spanish were driven from New Granada, and by 1826, all Spanish colonies in South America were finally independent. La Pola continues to define what patriotism stands for and inspires countless others to stand up for what is right, even in the face of adversity. If La Pola can face a firing squad at the young age of 21, then I, as a 19-year-old, and all of us as citizens of this shared world, can at least find the strength to stand up for what we know is right. Thank you.
Very nice, Arushi. And thank you so much, everyone, all the participants, for your amazing performances. And dosto, result announcement is at 3 p.m. Once again, kudos to all you there who have participated and shared your amazing knowledge, sharing, inspiration. And dosto, bahut sare surprises aane wale hain. We're going to start at 3 p.m. sharp with a musical program, and a lot many new announcements as well for all you out wonderful people there. And plus, okay, आपको ये पता है कि author Sherry जो है हमारे वो एक public speaking course लेकर आ रहे हैं, which is totally free of cost, and it's gonna start at 7th of November. Mind the date, 7th November, and it will end at 27th of November. 21 days program है. For more details, please contact the MS Talks team. And now I would like to request everyone to please log out, and I request jury members and the core team, please stay here for 5 minutes quick chat. This is host and host GJ Gaurav Jain signing off from MS Talks team. Thank you. Bye. We can stop the live. Thank you so much.
सागर लॉग आउट करो, किसकी वेट कर रहे हो?
या प्लीज रिक्वेस्ट एवरीवन टू लॉग आउट एंड कैन वी स्टॉप द लाइव प्लीज? गुरदीप,
अजंता, विद्युत, प्रतीक्षा, आप सब लॉग आउट करो प्लीज। गुरदीप लॉग आउट करो आप। रुचि आप भी लॉग आउट करो। विद्युत, प्रतीक्षा प्लीज। साइबर अनमोल आप भी लॉग आउट करें प्लीज।